There are tens of thousands of emails that hackers have released in the last 3 days of the Democratic Party, of George Soros, and of other criminal organizations. And you're only going to see more of those leaks coming out in the days and weeks to come, in the 80 days that we've got out from the election. 80 and change. In fact, how many days exactly is it? I want to 83 days. And notice what's in the George Soros emails, thousands and thousands and thousands of them that folks are digging through. Global government, open up Europe, condition everyone in Europe and the U.S. to accept collapsing borders, and then bring in the groups and organize them and basically skim money off the top of the welfare they're given to siphon it back into the big foundations and back into the criminal combines. Where did I hear this before? In my documentary films, on the radio, and in the stories at Infowars.com. Because we don't need these emails to know this. It is on record that this is their plan at the United Nations. It's just interesting to see Soros directing it from behind the scenes. The video that we shot on Saturday is titled Shocker. UN admits migrant crisis plan to overthrow the West. And in their own words, they say basically get rid of white people. Now, they're selling this to the 90%+ of the planet that isn't white, and most of which happen to be third world, that this is a reverse colonialism conquering the West. The third world populations are being used as cannon fodder. Remember the global government treaty that was leaked in 2008, the Copenhagen text? And what did it say? That they were going to right at double. It was right below doubling, 1 point below doubling the taxes on the third world that the West would pay. The third world has been looted and robbed by the mega corporations that don't operate in free market but operate as combines since the days of the British East India and Dutch East India Company. And it's that model that is the planetary government we now face. And we have George Soros, that never saw a scam he didn't love, who's overthrown scores of countries, devalued their currencies in the West and in the third world. And now you have Daily Caller and others digging through the emails. Top story on DrudgeReport.com. Kingdom of Soros. Influence world with refugee crisis. Cash for social justice. And they admit that first they tell you it's 100,000, it's really a million. Then they tell you it's 2 million, it's 5 million, and that they're going to flood everybody with these folks and then restrict our free speech through social media and ban our speech and not let us criticize it. We already saw that happen in Europe. I called it before Germany and France declared civil emergencies. And again, I'm not up here bragging, I called it. We know the enemy program. And we have to organize against it and expose it. It is the mega offshore rich, diplomatically immune, above the law, tax exempt, organizing the desperate third world to bring down what's left of independent wealth the globalists don't control, because they implement. Just like you see a cop car and it says tax exempt. The cop themselves isn't a bad person, but that idea that the state is tax exempt and can give state powers to private corporations, making themselves exempt, they then organize higher taxes on everybody else, bring in third world populations to be their enforcers, and it's game over. By the way, that's actually in the documents as well. How they're going to use the illegals as the new constabulary. That means the enforcers. But first, they have to remove the old constabulary. I'm Alex Jones. This is the program to defeat globalism. Ladies and gentlemen, we have to have a little bit of fun with the decline of civilization. We have to have some gallows humor, but this is going to be an incredible transmission today. Particularly, we have a major Stanford Research Institute study confirming Democratic election fraud on a massive scale to steal the election from Bernie Sanders. Now, I know you already know that. I know we chronicled that here on air. And the Republicans tried the same thing with Donald Trump, but because he fought back, they failed. And that is a lesson to us on every front about fighting back. But that is the big news today. And it's in even places like U.S. News and World Report. It's even in the Associated Press. Here's another headline. Can the 2016 election be rigged? You bet. That's out of the Hill newspaper. Meanwhile, Debbie Wasserman Schultz has come out and admitted, this came out a few days ago, it's she said it on tape, but now it's getting some traction, that she was there in the Democratic National Committee to make sure Hillary got the nomination. Now, of course, she's denied this previously, but this is like CNN coming out and saying, you know, we're doing everything we can to get Hillary elected. Everybody's like, wow, they admit it. They admit it. I was watching Fox News this weekend, and they said, coming up, is there bias in the media against Donald Trump? So I sat there and I waited till they finally got to that piece, and they weren't sure. They weren't sure on Fox News if there was bias. They weren't sure. This is the level of idiocy and how stupid they think we are. So we're going to be getting to all of that today. That they stole the election from the Bernie Sanders voters, and that's a fact. And they can have Rachel Maddow and Chris Hayes and everybody sit up there and make jokes and sit up there and edit together videos of things I've said in the last 20 years, try to make us look silly, but we have been pushing more than anybody else but Drudge the narrative that we should have free and open elections. And if you want to say we're bad people because of that, please throw me in that briar patch, because I'm very proud of the fact that we've been exposing it. We've had a huge effect stopping it in the case of Trump. And we are continuing to force that narrative out there and have been proven right by the Stanford Research Institute and other major studies. It is a fact that this is going on. And there, it is a fact that having poll watchers and exposing this may make them be forced to back down. So we're not going down without a fight here. Now, let me tell you what else is coming up. We've talked about this some in the last month, but now it's confirmed. U.S. nukes in Turkey vulnerable to terrorists and other hostile forces think tank. And that means basically Ergun capturing them. That's code for that. That's RT. This is AP. China's launch of quantum satellite, major step in space race. Military first for Iran as Russian bombers based on its territory launch airstrikes on Syria. Scientists built a mini black hole out of sound waves. Burned down white suburbs. There's new developments there. Brexit unlikely before 2019. Flight attendants caught on video spraying pesticide on passengers. Investigations reveal routine practice. In fact, we've had crew members that have been on planes recently where they're spraying pesticide and saying, it's not harmful, don't worry. Fluoride's not harmful either. Neither's a hatchet upside the head. Speaking of hatchets upside the head, France and other countries are having to shut down large stretches of road because the migrant invaders that resemble a zombie horde of military-age men are killing people with hatchets and hammers and robbing their cars en masse. Total bedlam is descending into those countries by design, and now they're developing a national police force for each of those countries, from Sweden to Germany to France, and they admit that they are linking up with Muslim leaders online to arrest anyone criticizing Islam in any way. The London mayor has also announced an initiative to arrest you and your family. Now, we have this from the new George Soros emails. Now, I told you this is the battle plan. In fact, Saturday we shot a video showing public statements from the UN lead envoy who heads up the migration program and immigration program, the migrant program. And we broke all of this down with the headline, UN admits, shocker, UN admits migrant crisis plan to overthrow the West. And we're going to post this Daily Caller article on Infowars.com, where now we have all the emails double proving this. We're just going to under it put my video from Saturday that I came up here and shot, just exposing this. But now we just don't have it from Peter Sutherland. And, of course, in the video, I finger Soros and explain that he funded the Arab Spring, the Ukraine overthrow, what's happening here. This is really happening. But let's just go over the stack of news today on this subject alone. Mega banks above the law, tax-exempt, diplomatic immunity, going in with education programs to create absolute, total, homicidal hatred of anyone with white skin and teaching them to hate capitalism and teaching them that you must go to the United States or Europe or Australia and you must capture it politically as leftist and that you must then take over government and create a utopia. Now, this is taught in Mexico. This is taught in Nigeria. This is taught in Sudan. This is taught in South Africa. This is taught all over places like Venezuela, Nicaragua, El Salvador. They're all running programs as of this year, officially organized with the UN to bring in people from all over the world that land on airplanes and come in on ships. They're not allowed to stay there. And then they are bussed all the way to the United States, where the Border Patrol waits for them and loads them on buses to ship them into Democratic Party facilities, who then they give them ID cards, set them up on full welfare, more than a Social Security recipient, and then large portions of that money is skimmed and given back to the organized crime combine. You saw shadows of this, tracings of this. We're going to skip the network break. It's too important. I mean, I'm serious. This is just the end of the country, the end of the world we're talking about here. And the Border Patrol even comes out and says, we've been ordered to complete the smuggling process. That's how mega massive all this is. So let's continue. Hillary's VP, we have the video of this coming up. Hillary's VP, whites must become a minority to atone for racism. Now, again, this is the ultimate racism. To experience what other people have gone through, because only whites have oppressed anybody in history, total lie, we must make whites a minority so they can be persecuted, is what he's saying. And this is a white guy who's going to lead this and organize all the different racial groups who they're going to put your kids in prison and teach them in the prison how, according to different racial groups, how to kill each other. He's going to manage you, but he's selling it to you, the party of the KKK, as your new time to shine. This is incredible. In fact, let's just play the clip of the man that would be the vice president, probably the president, when Hillary, that brain tumor goes ahead and eats the rest of that melon. Here it is.
For instance, the most segregated hour of the week is 11 o'clock Sunday morning, and that was a challenge to me. And so I've made my spiritual home in a neighborhood where we're not segregated. In fact, we were, when we started there, one of a few white families in that church. It's now a very well-integrated church, but it was important to, especially I think the burden is on those of us who are in a majority, you know, Caucasians here. We got to put ourselves in situations where we're in the minority.
Okay, so there are, the world is officially 90% non-Anglo. And then if you look at the numbers, there's about 3% of that are people that are identifying as Anglo that you could argue aren't. 7% of the planet is Anglo, okay? But you would think it is the end of the world that white people even exist. So I apologize for Europe, and I apologize for the printing press, and I apologize for the science and the medicine and everything else, and I just am here to say this guy's absolutely right. No, this is a sick, evil race pimp. With George Soros in there funding absolute racial division and racial programs to create hatred between different groups of people and balkanization. Just as they looked at the numbers in Ukraine and said, we're going to go with a right-wing Nazi movement to overthrow the government. And they're going to break the lines between Catholic and Orthodox. They go in with anthropologists and sociologists, and they decide how to game the system. That's all declassified. That's all admitted. It's not my opinion. It's an absolute total fact. And now we have more emails from the hack inside of the Soros Foundation with them breaking down what they're doing. And they don't even use code words, okay? UN Migration Envoy believes EU should undermine national homogeneity. Goes on to say Europe is white. That must be stopped. That is the former founder of the EU, Peter Sutherland, top globalist. That is, again, BBC, you name it. Here's the latest, Daily Caller. Leaked Soros memo, refugee crisis, quote, new normal. See, it's meant to just totally open the border, merge with the Middle East, North Africa. Gives new opportunities for global influence. And he goes in to talk about skimming money off the people once they go into the social safety net, organizing them as a political detonator group that is under the control of the leftist combines. I know you've already heard this every day for years here, but just here it is, exactly as I told you, the exact plan. And it just goes on from there. Soros hack reveals plot behind Europe's refugee crisis. Media manipulation, cash for social justice. Call in the groups, keep them poor, keep them under your control, get them on welfare, detonate, burn cities, and then start banning people's free speech that criticize your own program. Advertise Europe's open. Advertise all the free goodies are there. We're getting to that next. Get ready for it. Boom. London mayor to set up police online hate crime hub. This guy is a Muslim. He admits he wants Sharia law. He says he will not follow the Brexit and will make London an Islamic state, basically. They are banning images of women in bathing suits on city-owned property billboards and buses. Hitting and hitting hard. They're putting Muslim police chiefs in almost everywhere. I mean, it is and the reign of terror is on. Again, it's not a Muslim takeover, per se, in this phase. It's that they will enforce. They understand political power and the will to control and to be brought in as a client state to do it. You ought to read what the Sikhs are saying about this, the poor Sikhs that have been battling Muslims for over 1,000 years out of India. And they're the poor ones that when some idiot moron goes in and sees people with turbans, you know, they'll go do a mass shooting occasionally of the poor Sikhs. The Sikhs are out there warning people, this is what the Muslims did in India. You better watch out. They're going to end up being your police chiefs. And it's already happened. It's a total plan. We're totally sold out, folks, with a weirdo Nazi collaborator running it. Now, listen to this. London mayor to set up police online hate crime hub in partnership with social media firms. Already in Germany, they're arresting people, and Facebook has hired the former Stasi to run it. Then they call the police. You get arrested for criticizing open borders in any way. Now it started in London. In fact, Paul's going to have to move here because of it. The office of the London's, he's already been threatened, already had phone calls. It's already on. The office of the London's first Muslim mayor, so he isn't wasting time, has secured millions of pounds to fund a police online hate crime hub to work in partnership with social justice media providers to criminalize trolls who target individuals and communities. Here's another one. Locals warned to stay away from main roads as migrants smash vehicles. Migrants wielding bats and knives have been smashing up vehicles on roads in Calais as the owners sit in traffic, reportedly just for fun. Local residents are warning others to avoid the area, saying that the migrants are not even checking to see whether children are in the vehicles because they set upon them. Well, it's not Islamic, though. It's okay if they, you know, run over kids with a truck. It's not Islamic. One resident has posted pictures on Facebook of their brother-in-law's car, which sustained more than 500 pounds worth of damage as a dozen migrants, you mean illegal alien invaders, set about them with bats completely smashing the side mirror and rear window. You're leaving work, and then you're attacked by migrants. Just for fun, it disgusts me, said Mava Mila in a post which has been shared more than 6,000 people. Yeah, France has declared, and other places, civil emergencies. I mean, we've shown you the videos. There's thousands of them on YouTube of just burning trucks, mobs of people dragging families out of vehicles, stabbings, murders, hatchet attacks. It's all just an orgy of enjoyment. And again, Hillary's up there with Mateen's father, the mass shooter at the nightclub, right behind her at the VIP area, letting everybody know, this is it. Merkel goes to the refugee centers. It's all men, and says, we love you. We're sorry. We're here to help you. As France extends its state of emergency. So we've got that report, but it's okay. Oregon State to force social justice training on freshmen to make sure you learn to submit to all of this and learn how to be beat up, like in San Francisco State College there, where you've got the little trendy white kid in you know, I guess with dreadlocks and stuff, and the two trendies come over and beat him up because he's expropriating culture. See, there's no way to submit to this. You can organize any culture, whether it's Catholic against Orthodox or Hutus against Tutsi black African tribes because one lives on the other side of the river, or Hispanic against white, or white against black. You can organize this crap any way you want, and that's what they've done. They're organizing it. They're launching it. Oregon State to force social justice training on freshmen. Now everyone must go. Oregon State University is developing an online course centered on social justice that new students will soon be required to take. This is how you control civilization. This is how you roll in the robots. This is how you roll in the total surveillance. It's how you roll in the GMO, how you assault all of humanity, replacing their jobs, building a world where humans are obsolete. Is you first teach everyone to fight with each other, and you break up the family, and you divide culture. U.S. accepts more Syrian refugees than all of the EU. New report. London Thought Police special unit to track down online trolls. Yes. Clinton campaign launches voter registration effort led by illegal aliens. Can't make that up. Illegal immigration surges past 2015. Totals with 2 months still to go in fiscal year. Border Patrol, Washington Times. My goodness, isn't that just special? Now, when we come back, I'm going to drill into what I already mentioned in more detail. Stanford University confirms Democratic election fraud. Boom, Donald Trump, InfoWars, Drudge, right again. Boom. And then we're going to get into the latest on what's happening with globalization and more on the Soros emails as Obama and the Soros-funded groups hit the Midwest telling them globalism, NAFTA, GATT, the TPP will deliver you to heaven. And Gary Johnson, the Goldman Sachs stooge, loves it. We'll be back. I'm Alex Jones.
We're on the march. The empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Government. Use weaponized, collapsing third world populations who they fill full of a political operating system of kill the West, destroy Whitey, while the elites sit back in their armored fortresses and watch society collapse, and so they can then consolidate control. They are putting Europe into a collapse paradigm. And they're putting the rest of the world into that collapse paradigm as well. It is incredible. The good news is the military and the police know what's happening. The intelligentsia knows what's happening. And people in third world countries and old world countries know what's happening. And that's why you see the whole world against Soros now. And that means his minions, Hillary Clinton and others. You see the whole world, all these different groups, leaks from inside the Pentagon, leaks from inside the Secret Service, exposing these monsters as humanity awakens. I'm going to break all this down coming up here in a moment. Then I intend to have Doug Hagman of the Northeast Intelligence Network join us to talk about the intel they've got of what dirty tricks Hillary may play going into the last 83 days of this election. We talked to our contact. We talked to our pipeline to the Secret Service. And they added some very important information dealing with Hillary staging a false flag against herself, an assassination attempt that lines up with our other information that comes from another source, from another agency, and also confirming other information about what they're having to do to keep her from going into epileptic seizures. So I'm going to have Joe Biggs pop in for about 10 minutes. He's in Milwaukee with the rest of the crew, Jakari, Jackson, and Rob Dew. They're going to be covering the Donald Trump rally coming up this evening from inside and outside in a suburb of Milwaukee. So if InfoWarriors want to come out for that, that's very, very important to do tonight. You just look at Donald J. Trump's website and find the exact precise location. I'll announce that later as well. But before I go any further and also get into what's happening in the economy front, ancient defense is very, very hard for us to keep in stock because it's got so many ingredients in it that we want to keep at California level standards, which means they basically have to be so clean it's almost impossible, that there has to be so much testing of the raw materials that a lot of times it takes up to 6 months to get living defense back into stock. We also, again, have the herbal version that's liquid, ancient defense. But living defense, a lot of times, is sold out for up to 6 months. Despite the fact that it's going to sell out in the next 3-4 days, and it'll probably be a month till we get more in, but we're getting better about getting it in quicker and sourcing it, we are still offering 20% off right now. So I want to encourage everybody out there to take advantage of this and to go read why Living Defense, but also Ancient Defense, is so important, but specifically Living Defense. It's got wildcrafted black walnut, green hull, and then it just goes on from there. I'm not going to read to you all the known herbs and known plant-derived compounds that for thousands of years have been known to safely and in a healthy way flush the body of parasites. This is something that from the research we've done and what Dr. Grip says you should do twice a year, and you just take a few of the caplets a day. It's a powder, so you have better absorbability, and it is simply amazing what happens. In fact, I have been back on a parasite cleanse myself and have been taking this for the last week, and just the things that are in it are already so good for your body on top of it. This is the ultimate formulation for a parasite detox, in my opinion. And your purchase, again, of the product makes everything we do here possible. I cannot stress enough the obvious value of having this broadcast and having it expand in the face of the globalist, for us to be able to send our reporters around the country and around the world, for us to be able to have nightly news and special programs and documentaries, and to have our writers and researchers. You can see how our analysis is spot on. You can see how our analysis of the globalist operations is changing the world. And that's not hype. That's not talk. That's not bragging. It's fact. I'm not here telling you that so that, oh, I'm a big shot. I'm telling you that you are the InfoWar. You're the reason this operation is so successful. InfoWars is the ship. Our crew are the sails and the rigging and the brains of the operation. But you are the ocean and the wind which propels the craft. Without you, we're dead in the water. So you are just as important as the ship itself. In fact, you're... support of us built the ship itself. You are not just the wind. When you decide to promote an article, when you decide to share a link, Drudge, it came out yesterday, and mainstream news, is the number one website, news website in the world. InfoWars is 80-something, up 10 points in ranking. And that's using real Google Analytics, and that's what the even mainstream media breaks down and says. Bigger than the New York Times, bigger than Facebook, all of it combined, more traffic on Drudge. Number one, beating out Fox, beating out CNN, beating out all of it. Now, what does that tell you about them? It tells you they're a joke. And look at how InfoWars is growing. And look at how the information we cover is now being covered by Breitbart, is now being covered by the Daily Caller, is now being covered by even mainstream news. Because what we're saying is the truth. And I've never wanted to be underground and always on the outside and just failing and being a beautiful loser who's too cool and nobody gets me. And, you know, I run around at coffee shops and I'm into myself. And, oh, my gosh, I'm so intellectual. I'm just a person of the people who wants liberty and common sense, who is taking action and wreaking havoc to the New World Order. And trying to get other people to realize that their very future depends on this. And the globalists hate you and hate your family. And you should take that personal. We're being usurped by a form of 21st century warfare. We are under attack. This is the 21st century war. It's economic. It's replacing humans. It's destroying the family. It's turning us all against each other. This is a scientific attack. And they tell you what they're doing in the movie The Kingsman. They dumb it down that a wavelength's being sent out over the cell phones to cause our primitive brains to kick on and make us kill each other. That is a dumbed-down allegory of what's actually going on. And it's a billionaire working with other billionaires to wipe out the population of the Earth 99% to bring in a utopia. Now, you may have heard of that theme before, Moonraker, written in the 50s by Ian Fleming, high-level OSS and then MI6, telling you what globalists were talking about. The allegory of going up into space while you bioweapon the whole Earth, the pathogen, the biological pathogen, runs its course, phases out, is designed to mutate until it's no longer harmful, and you return to Earth and repopulate it with your eugenics dream. They're telling you the plan. But they're going to do it in slow motion. Because while they poison us and kill us and torture us slowly, they want to find cures for themselves. So while they're testing all of this on us, they're looking for mutations. They're looking for what they call the Lazarus gene. They're looking for immortal cell lines. And let me give you a newsflash. They have found immortal cell lines that never die. Think about that. Look it up. Only flame kills them. The globalists know we're not in Kansas anymore, and it's time for all of us to figure out we're not in Kansas anymore. Now, just like I tell you, George Soros is planning to flood the West with third world populations, to weaponize them, to have them all have chips on their shoulders, and to have them be political tools to burn down any city whenever he wants. Basically, all admitted, all come out, they'd use them as weapons, skim the money off the top they got from social welfare programs. It's all coming out because here's what's happening. The intelligence agencies, who aren't perfect, realize that there's no future under this new world order. And I don't care whether it's MI6 or the CIA or the FBI or who it is, the Russians, everybody is coming together and realizing this new world order has got to be stopped. I mean, we're going to let some 87-year-old crazy Nazi collaborator freakazoid blow up the West and bring us into world financial ruin because he wants to lord over a bunch of poor people because he's an asshole? Excuse me using that term. I apologize. Because it's not strong enough for him. He is a demonic demon who wants to run the world. And, of course, he can't do that because of business. He can't do it because of free market. He can't dominate, so he has to blow it all up to say he rules it. I've got to read this. Hold on one second. Okay. Remember that thing I said earlier about that particular article? Like I said, post it under our byline. Entire thing, please. Thank you. And I'm dealing with some other stuff right now. I'm dealing with some other news that is so over the top. That's why the globalists get away with what they do, because the things they do are just so incredibly crazy. Finishing up, though, going back to the plug, Living Defense is now 20% off for a limited time because we're going to have to hold some back for folks that are signed up for auto ship. You can get free shipping when you sign up for auto ship. And you can also get free shipping when you get orders of $50 or more and 10% off when you sign up for auto ship. So InfoWarsLife.com or InfoWarsStore.com is the umbrella site. Also, the new film Armageddon is out. It's the director's cut, exclusively available for the next week or so at InfoWarsStore.com. You get a second copy and you get two of my films free. And there's a bunch of different variants where you can choose which two of my films you want free, like Matrix of Evil or Fall of the Republic or America Destroyed by Design. All available at InfoWarsStore.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139. And again, that is the oxygen that helps fund the fires of liberty. Let's get into this now. I mentioned it earlier, but think about what a big deal this is. Stanford University confirms Democratic election fraud. This is being reported on by the Hill newspaper and many others. That's really got to be upsetting the establishment. The bombshell study released by Stanford University confirms evidence of election fraud during the 2016 Democratic Party primaries. According to a paper released this week entitled, "We Are Witnessing a Dishonest Election," a state comparison based on voting procedures used during the election reveals endemic election fraud within the system. That's at the top. Election fraud is not voter fraud. Given the stakes in the outcome of the American presidential elections, ensuring the integrity of the electoral process is of the utmost importance. And there's going to be more hacks. A little bird told me there were other hacks that have certain parties directing the fraud and preparing in the general election and organizing the illegals to vote and the dead people to vote. Oh, I'm afraid all the emails will be released before you have the election. And no amount of false flags, Soros, are going to put that genie back in the little bottle. You can run on for a long time, creepy man. Are the results we are witnessing in the 2016 primary elections trustworthy? While Donald Trump enjoys a clear and early edge over the Republican rivals, the Democratic contest between former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton and Senator Bernie Sanders has been far more competitive. And then it goes back to articles where they tried to spin the whole thing, but where they did end up stealing it from Bernie Sanders. Now, let's go ahead and get to this article that Roger Stone wrote for the Hill newspaper. He also sent it to us to post at Infowars.com. Can the 2016 election be rigged? You bet. Donald Trump has said publicly that he fears the next election will be rigged based on both technical capability and recent history. Trump's concerns are not unfounded. A recent study by Stanford Research University provided that Hillary Clinton's campaign rigged the system to steal the nomination from Bernie Sanders. What does that mean to Bernie Sanders in Wisconsin? It's stunning. And then it goes on to the history of that. Politico profiled a Princeton professor who has demonstrated how the election voting machines that are most widely used can be hacked in 5 minutes or less. Robert Fratrakis, who I want to get on, professor of political science in the Social and Behavioral Sciences Department at Columbus State Community College, has written a must-read book on the strip and flip technique used to rig these machines. Professor is a Green Party activist, in case you're thinking he's some Republican. A computer hacker showed CBS News last week how to vote multiple times using a $15 electronic device. Again, they've designed these things to be defrauded. But listen, then they argue, well, nobody's announcing it nationally, so you can't steal it nationally because you can only steal it locally and then just hope that enough local thefts allow whoever the system wants to get into power, get into power. No, they have a secretive group made up of six media outlets headed up by the Associated Press, formerly Voter News Services. Now it's got two or three new names to confuse the public, that just announces who the winners are. And listen, I know our audience already knows this. I'm just pointing out that more and more it's coming out that this is going on and that it's very, very exciting to see this unfolding and see this happening, because Donald Trump standing up to election fraud is shining more light on this critical issue than we've ever seen before, because we finally have a candidate that actually is calling fraud for what it is. Stay with us. Well, the police chief has come out and pointed out that the problem the last three nights in Milwaukee, after a black police officer shot a black armed man with a felony record, was stirred up by the Communist Party that had been brought in from Chicago. And that is what we experience basically every single time. Now, I want to be clear here. This is not about a referendum on the police. It's not about saying the police are perfect or there aren't bad cops or legislatures aren't passing bad laws that are unconstitutional and putting police officers in an unconstitutional role. I have big issues with it and always have, but I'm not mentally ill. If a bad cop does something somewhere else and then someone randomly shoots another cop, that's called craziness. And we have globalists trying to destabilize this country and other countries, and we have their own emails and their own battle plans. But I don't need a Soros hack. The UN admits they're doing this. The UN, the State Department admits they spent $5 billion starting 6 years ago to overthrow Ukraine, overthrow an elected government. And they started it talking about police brutality and using cases in the media that Soros and others were funding to make the police emblematic of the evil government. And the government was doing some bad stuff. And the police had done some bad things. But the point is, foreign outside interest came in and stirred it all up to get a shooting war going. Now, shooting wars are bad for business, bad for kids going to school, bad for stock markets. See, we got a big, wealthy country. It's got problems. But we sure don't need to burn it all down, do we, to fix the problem? No. And by the way, if poor people get induced by an evil mastermind to burn down their own neighborhoods, that doesn't help them, does it? I'm going to end up being just fine because I'm a wise person. I know how things work. I've made preparations. So if I disliked people in the inner city, I'd be like George Soros, inducing them with change agents on the ground, foundation funded, to burn this baby to the ground. It's such a sick joke. And Sheriff David Clark, who I just love, we need to get him back on the show. He's been on many times. He has come out and said, listen, let's get off the police for a minute. It's about ghetto reform. And it's about the culture of helplessness and what's happening and the fact that Milwaukee's getting poorer, folks. Doesn't matter what color you are. The country's falling apart. And you got nasty, evil, big foundations from Chicago. They're little commie fronts. The Weatherman 2.0. Literally. That's what he said. Coming in to do this. It's a joke. It's a joke. It's a joke. Milwaukee's liberal. Milwaukee has incredible integration. Milwaukee, people get along. Milwaukee's not racist on average. It's a load of bull. Black cop shoots a black guy waving a gun. That is not a reason to go around burning stuff down for George Soros. Let's play the clip.
Serves as an igniter, there's no doubt, but to an already volatile situation, a volatile mix of urban pathologies, failed urban policy that exacerbates inescapable poverty, failing public schools, inadequate parenting, father absent homes. We all know when fathers are not around to shape the behavior of young boys, they oftentimes grow up to be unmanageable misfits that the police have to deal with in an aggressive fashion, killed. But I think it's important to point out as well, because we tend to gloss over this stuff. We keep focusing on the police. We keep focusing on the police. And I've said publicly before, stop trying to fix the police, fix the ghetto. And I talked about those urban pathologies.
All right, great points. The full video's up on Infowars.com. We got a bunch of clips coming up and a guest. Stay with us. This is important, folks. We have their own battle plans to bring our countries down. Soros needs to be arrested right now. If he goes to Russia, he will be. FBI and others. But he was saying Obama was going to try to start a destabilization race war and that George Soros was involved. And I just thought, hey, the establishment's already running everything. Why would they do that? And we've got a police state they're setting up. Won't that control everything? Why would they want to destabilize stuff? But I tell you, everything he talked about came true. And he's given us amazing information over the years before any of this, you know, race riot stuff even started up. So he's going to be joining us coming up at the start of the next segment. And I want to bounce a lot of stuff off of him that we've gotten from the Secret Service. And by the way, when I talk about that, I'm not even proud of that. Getting handed a lit stick of dynamite, basically. It's something I got to do. It's a responsibility I've got to have. Folks would say it's prestigious to have the Secret Service leak information to you. I mean, in their history, they don't really do that. Because I had Dan Bongino on yesterday, and I said, why do you think that's happening? And he was a former senior agent. He said, no, I don't doubt that's happening because the country's in so much trouble and the Secret Service is being persecuted and they know what criminals are dealing with. And I said, well, you know, what's an example? And he just said, It's worse than you know. Total trashiness. I mean, reportedly, Hillary talks like a sailor, just walks around with her sleeves rolled up, punching Bill Clinton in the face before she was so ill. I mean, she's a piece of work. And just, well, you know, stealing not just the cutlery and plates, but furniture. I mean, they are total criminals. They are trash. They are filth. Obama doesn't steal stuff out of the White House, and he's polite to people. The Clintons, I think the Clintons are worse than Obama. In fact, I'm sure of it. I mean, Obama's got some evil energy about him, and he wants to bring the U.S. down a few pegs, and he is an Islamicist. And he is trying to make Kenya go Islamic. He's a horrible person. He's horrible. But it really shows you something that Hillary, behind the scenes, isn't ever nice. It's one thing, you know, high pressure. This is media. I get mad. People have arguments. That goes on. But then I'm sorry for it later. My folks that are rude to me are sorry. I mean, she doesn't give people tips. You can't look her in the eyes. She loves to get people fired. She loves to fire people. She loves to rub stuff in. She loves to gloat over pettiness. Hillary Clinton does not give tips. I mean, I get a good feeling out of being middle class and having some extra money. And when somebody does good service, giving them a 20-25% tip. Bad service? I'm not sorry they complain, but if somebody's bad enough, I don't want to give them a tip, I call them over and say, you're rude and you need to get ahead in life and not act so, you know, have such an attitude problem. And then I'll say, I mean, my family hates when I do this, but I'm all about getting past comfort zones. And I'll say real nice, and I'll say, something wrong? Yeah, I'm really having a bad day. Okay, well, you still have a 15% tip then, but try having a better attitude. You really, you know, gave us attitude and everything, and it makes me not want to come to this restaurant anymore. See, I mean, I'm all about really getting past comfort zones with people. And political correctness is all about being all creeped out and scared of everybody, and no one talks with everybody, and nobody actually hangs out with each other, so that it's this sick form of basically segregation where we're all forcibly integrated with each other, but to fight with each other. It is absolute mind control. And they admit it is. And it's run. I just keep going back to this. I've got hundreds of news articles. I'm not going back to this for lack of news coverage. It feels good, though, to see it be a top news story in the country that George Soros' emails are how they're purposely behind the illegals coming in, purposely behind the immigrant invasion to balkanize Europe, destabilize things, and then milk the social services networks that the big banks and others make money off of and administer. You have to understand, these socialist democratic parties, they make all these illegals they come in basically work for them and do all sorts of scams for them and tax returns, fake tax returns. It's like Acorn. Into the second hour of this global transmission, our reporters are on the ground in Milwaukee. They're going to be covering the Trump event in a Milwaukee suburb in Wisconsin tonight, where the communists and others have promised violence. We, of course, knew from our Chicago police sources that indeed Hillary and the DNC were ordering hundreds and hundreds of demonstrators dressed as Bernie Sanders supporters and were busing them in paid to attack Trump supporters in Chicago and then in other areas. The media then blamed Trump and Bernie supporters. That way you hurt Trump voters and you hurt Sanders voters helping Hillary. That's how divide and conquer works. This is very elementary, what Soros is doing. Overthrew Ukraine with Catholics and Orthodox fighting each other. Orthodox in the East, Catholics in the West. Same split Hitler used in World War II. They look at sociology. They look at anthropology. They use cultural psychology. That's why they admit the CIA hires what group, number one, most often, what degree? Sociologists. And they like people that have combat experience who then get a sociology degree on top of it. Then they want you to get an anthropology degree. And we sit here like morons getting our chain pulled. And when I say CIA, I mean the globalists that have basically set it up to take this country and the world over. The CIA is a foreign, alien, globalist organization. Does that mean there aren't good people in the CIA? Half the time, the most bold whistleblowers we have on are CIA or former CIA. We've had quite a few guests that end up getting killed. This isn't a game. This isn't a joke. This is real, people. And I had Dan Bongino on, former top Secret Service agent. He ran the foreign details, saying what we say about Obama and Hillary and all the rest of it is worse than what we're saying. And I told him, I said, RNC ran into the Secret Service. We had the highest level badges. That was national media. We were given the highest level badges by the Trump campaign. I'm not going to get an inside baseball, but we could go anywhere we wanted. Anywhere. Right through the Secret Service, you name it. And Secret Service reached out to us. I handed it off to Joe Biggs because he's good at keeping stuff secret with his Army background. We set up a liaison, and they said in the next few weeks you're going to get key intel, and it came through, confirming everything we already see in the news. The Parkinson's, the neurological disorders, the falling down, the special handicap systems that lower to the ground so she can get in the SUVs. And the fact that they're thinking about, and this is the new intel, how to make the announcement that she's so ill and will they have to replace her. Biggs got contacted by our pipeline, I'll say, last night with more information and confirming the intel we got from a other government agency, let's just say military, of a meeting in California. And you know all about these meetings with the vice president and or the vice presidential candidate, Kane, and with the Soros people and all that going on around the country. Okay, it was one of those type meetings. And they just couldn't believe that in the cars leaving the hangars and when they're there running security at these mansions, these people are just sitting around openly in front of security blabbering about incredible crime. And I think that's why the Secret Service is so freaked out. And I brought this up to Bongino, and he didn't doubt that we'd had this leak, which is incredibly dangerous, folks. I just want you to understand, this is, I'm doing my duty here bringing this out. It's like, oh, we got some big story for you. Notice mainstream media attacks me all the time on stuff. Silence about our leak. Come out and say I'm a liar. Hey, why didn't the Secret Service drop by? You notice silence because they're at the top trying to figure out what to do right now. Because no one else is willing to put these leaks out but InfoWars and Drudge and folks like the Northeast Intelligence Network. Now, he's going to be with us if he can 20 minutes into the next hour. And then our reporters are coming on from Milwaukee. Doug Hagman, I've been hearing him for 15 years on the radio. And I had him on 7-8 years ago. And he was talking about how Obama's going to try to have a race war. They try to overthrow the country. And they're going to create all this division. And they hadn't really kicked all this off yet. And I was like, really, Hagman? But, you know, the guy had good credentials. And a lot of folks I respect said he was a good source. And so he runs a large, you know, police and, you know, a training facility, training with dogs, you name it. Works with the FBI, works with a lot of police departments. So you know, he's a good source. We started getting him on. And more, everything he's talked about has come true, not just because of his own research, but his sources. And we're going to go over the information we've gotten. Joe Biggs is going to be popping in later in the interview with more info he got from this conduit. I'll just leave it at that. And then I'm going to talk to him about how he thinks this whole plan is going. How's it going for Soros when we know that intelligence agencies, private corporations, and other groups are now hacking the Democratic Party, the entire Democratic Party, the entire Soros operation, the Clintons? It's all going to get data dumped. And I've been contacted now to confirm. Earlier stuff was the Russians. The carbon taxes being exposed, the high of the decline, climate gate stuff, that is the Russians. And the Russians are actively penetrating stuff. But this is not the Russians. That this is U.S. intelligence agencies leaking right now, risking their lives. Because they know something we don't know about Hillary that's so bad, it's finally turned basically the whole government against them. And we're getting word of what that is. Hillary Clinton is a communist Chinese agent. She is on the payroll of the Saudis. We already know that. But that they have engaged in treason never before seen. This is just such a dangerous time to be alive, ladies and gentlemen. Everybody can feel it. You can see it. And the good news is there are so many leaks coming out from different angles in places, they can't get everybody. They can shoot this DNC computer expert four times in the back, who reportedly is the source to WikiLeaks. They can kill other people, but they can't kill everybody. And guess what? Folks are past being intimidated. The leaks are accelerating as the murders take place. So I don't know how they're going to try to handle this. A false flag, a staged attack on Hillary. That's the word we're hearing. But Doug Hagman of HagmanandHagman.com, thank you so much for joining us today. Throwing out a lot of points there. Where should we start?
Well, thanks, Alex. Listening to you, you're 100% accurate with what you're saying. Excuse me. And I think really it's important for me to point out that my sources are independent of your sources. And the information that I'm getting is certainly lining up with what you're getting. So it's really interesting. Hillary Clinton is as well as the DNC right now, they're in a duck or bleed type scenario. You've got everything coming out where it's the globalists are actually being exposed. They've had plans, of course, many plans, and their plans have gone awry because of the leaks, the exposures, the unintended consequences from the criminality behind the Clinton Foundation. So all of this together presents a duck or bleed scenario for the globalists.
Is it fair to say this, and I'm going to give you the floor, but I'm just so excited, that we're seeing good people in government and other areas stand up. We're actually seeing the good guys fight back, the good, you know, men and women stand up and take action. Because what I saw at the DNC was unbelievable. I mean, the police were like 80% awake and were my listeners, and I'm just one guy, and the Secret Service was totally awake. It was incredible. That's got to scare the New World Order. That's got to let them know their plans are going to hell. Go ahead.
Well, no, you're right. And I think there's a lot of acrimony right now. I just spoke a couple of days ago, well, over the weekend with a source I've got within once removed from DHS and then one inside the FBI. There's a lot of acrimony within the FBI because of Bill Clinton's thrashing of the FBI over his wife, Hillary, and the Clinton Foundation. So
that's amazing arrogance to say the FBI director is full of BS.
Yeah. I mean, so what we're seeing here, I think, is this pushback by the good people within the FBI to declare their name and say, wait a minute, we didn't sign up for this. And we certainly didn't agree necessarily with the findings and letting off Hillary Clinton from pursuing criminal charges. So all of this combined right now has got them on a track of retreat. And part of their retreat, I think, we're going to see an October surprise. And this is the latest information I received. And that October surprise kind of lines up with what you're saying about the disposition of Hillary Diane Rodham, the Witch Clinton, I call her. Perhaps we might not see her on the ticket in November. If not, where's she going to go? Well, perhaps because of her illness. Well, this is being talked about by my sources and apparently by yours. So, you know, these secret meetings with Soros and Tim Kaine, Soros and others, other globalists meeting behind closed doors, going to plan B. Now, at the epicenter of this, and I'll say this and I'll be quiet, but at the epicenter of
this. No, please. In fact, I'm going to skip this break, last one of the day. Go ahead.
I truly believe what we're seeing here with the riots, with the orchestrated riots in Wisconsin and elsewhere by Black Lives Matter and by other groups, by communist groups. We're seeing at the epicenter of this the attempt to hide the criminality of the Clintons, as well as the attempt to hide or perhaps even cause a reason to explain away the economic disaster that's about to fall us. And we know my source this past weekend, both of them said, think bigger than domestically. Look at the global situation and factor that into what you see taking place domestically. And we're seeing the pushback from the U.S. dollar in the petrodollar, that is. We're seeing that being put aside. We're seeing Turkey switching sides to go over with Russia. We're seeing ISIS now, an American CIA-funded cabal ISIS that is actually, again, you know, we are funding the wrong side of that, of course, and finding ourselves on the other side of Russia. We're seeing a dynamic switch of power in the Middle East, as well as the Silk Road caucus. So when you have
Hillary and Obama have been purposely destroying American power.
Yes.
In Soros's own words, to bring in globalism, but instead all it's doing is discrediting globalism.
Well, right, and I think that's the unintended consequence of what their policies have been. But again, I believe at the heart of this is the Keynesian economics, the destruction of the U.S. petrodollar, and the covering up of the calamity that will cause. And that's the riots, the racial division. And I spoke about this with
all
you
we've got is the fiat dollar and the petrodollar. We lose that. I mean, our industry's gone. Our farming's gone. No foreign army could do this to us. This is devastating.
Yeah, I mean, you. This is better, more effective than a foreign invasion. But we're seeing the foreign invasion.
And that's what Trump's saying. He's saying these economic policies amount to war.
Right, and he's absolutely 100% correct. So, you know, where are we at here? How do we put all this together? And again,
we're under attack. George Soros is the head of it. He needs to be dealt with.
There you go. We have to think bigger and look at the bigger picture, because at the very heart of this is the world economy, is the globalist. And of course, America is the speed bump between the new world order, shall we say, and the
even though
old,
it props it up, it's the schizophrenia of these people politically and economically and spiritually. Mr. Hagman, let me ask you this question. I know there's people above Soros, but he's one of the top kingpins. Why is this guy so politically bulletproof? I mean, he is a supervillain.
Oh, he's had decades and decades of practice at it. Plus, he's his contacts, money buys power. And of course, he's got no money problems. So you're looking at this infrastructure, I believe, where he is at the epicenter by way of his billions of dollars.
Oh, I agree. In fact, here's the key. It is hundreds of times bigger than Bernie Madoff's scam. He's got all the major world leaders tied into it. He's too corrupt to fail because he'll bring them all down with him. And that's why he's so hard to beat, because he's corrupted them. He's gotten so many people involved in corruption. He's been a Rothschild agent. He knows where all the bodies are buried. And so that's why he's such an arrogant sack of crap.
Amen to that. Yeah, you're exactly right. And so the bottom line here with this, and I was watching your broadcast running up to my appearance, and I would urge everyone to listen to what you've got to say. Listen to your sources, because your sources are echoing mine. We have different sources. You've got it with the CIA and other agencies. I've got it, DHS and the FBI. So when you combine these sources, we're seeing this, and you're right. This is a very dangerous time to be alive, but it's also an exciting time to be alive. However, we have to expect, I think, the unexpected, what people are not seeing.
Let's talk about that exactly. What's their plan B curveball? Because they are floundering right now.
Well, I think they need to retain their power at all costs. And how are they going to do that? If they can't do it through Hillary, Diane Rodham Clinton, then they've got to find some other way of doing it. But the other way of doing it would be to bring down the entire system, burn down the entire house, the global house, and then restructure it according to their Babylonian plans, if you will. So that's what I think they're looking at. They're looking at, if we can't win domestically, let's take down the entire house globally. Let's engage.
And that would be done with a war or economics or together, because we already see the German banks look like they're going to be the big detonator.
Well, and I think at the center of this too is the economic factor, the fragility of the petrodollar, the fact that they want to take down the U.S. dollar, they want to kill the U.S. dollar. They've said that for years. We've attempted to expose
that. That's Soros' admitted goal.
Yeah, exactly. So, and when that happens, we are already losing much of our buying power, which is reflected by the racial and societal acrimony we're seeing here in the United States play out. So is what we're seeing with respect to the civil riot or the riots and the civil unrest, is that a result of this loss of buying power, or is the loss of buying power reflected by the riots? I mean, we have to look at this with bigger glasses, not through a microscope, but through a larger lens here. And I think once
you see the big picture, 35,000 foot look down, do you agree with me or disagree? I think the New World Order is in deep trouble. They admit it's in deep trouble. They have articles in the Financial Times of London and scores of others saying world government's in trouble. We've got to get Hillary in or everything's going to unravel because of Brexit and now this. People are learning about diplomatic immunity. They're learning that big mega banks are immune from prosecution. They're learning about Soros. They're learning about how this super class is fomenting all this division around the world. And as soon as the public finally understands that down at the grassroots, I don't see how they can ever reverse their political comeuppance.
Well, maybe they can reverse it, but certainly they can eradicate many of the objectors to the new system. And you know, go back to the Georgia Guidestones, for example. You know, what's the objective there? To reduce the population.
So they're willing to do anything.
Oh, I have no doubt in my mind. And my source within the federal government, within the FBI said, trust me on this, these people are the most vicious, cannibalistic people that you'll ever meet behind closed doors. And now we're seeing it openly.
Well, let's go back to the FBI director. I mean, I know for a lot of people that are good people, they say, no, this guy really is good. He's trying to reform things. So I give him the benefit of the doubt. He comes out and for 80% of the speech, you know, a month ago, says she should be indicted. She's horrible. She's evil. But then says, but no prosecutors will do it. And then I sat back and kind of got angry. But then I thought about it more. Clearly now there's a war going on between DHS, sectors of DHS and the Justice Department on top, run by Lynch. And clearly there's leaks coming out from the other agencies trying to expose what's happening. And so from your sources, who is the FBI director and what does he really stand for? And why did he back down when the word was he really was going to call for Hillary to be indicted?
Well, just based on what I've been hearing, and these are from my sources within the FBI itself, Comey started out very good in terms of his intent, his desires. The investigation that he conducted was fair. Now, fair based on the parameters that they were given. So I'll give that caveat. They were hogtied from the beginning with certain issues with Hillary Clinton. They could have put her under oath. They didn't. They could have done a lot of things differently. So the
investigation was sabotaged from the beginning procedurally.
From the beginning. Yeah, yeah. However,
for folks that don't know, they can use our Constitution against us. If they set it up where things aren't done right, you can't do it because it's been foiled.
Right, right. And imagine this, though. Imagine being the FBI director recommending criminal charges and then not having the Justice Department pick up the mantle and say, okay, we're going to pursue this based on your recommendations. Well, obviously, that would put Comey in a really bad position, not only with the public, the perception of the public, but within his own rank and file, within his people, within the FBI.
What about the new investigations, criminal probes of the State Department Foundation, where it's been proven that the State Department and the Foundation were acting as one?
Well, and there's right now you got three independent investigations taking place right now with respect to the Foundation. Three U.S. attorneys are involved, three separate investigations, plus you've got a subcommittee, a Senate subcommittee about ready to look at this as well. You've got all of this overlap between the Clinton Foundation, other NGOs, the people within the State Department as well. If this goes in the direction against Clinton, against Hillary Clinton and Bill and their associates, then this is why they're going to have to do something, I suspect. Contrary to the big talkers like Rush Limbaugh and others who say, well, you know, we nothing's going to happen. Well, wait a minute. Certainly it could happen, especially given the attitude by the FBI.
Well, I'll tell you this, and again, I'm not bragging. It was shocking because I've been to a couple DNCs and RNCs, and I've been around the Secret Service a bunch, and they do seem generally focused, professional, almost dog-like, you know, in their duty. But state police, local police, other cops they brought in, Secret Service, federal marshals, I was a rock star at the RNC. We wouldn't even show it on camera because I didn't want to get these people in trouble. I was like, look, don't cheer me in public and salute me and all this stuff. Because, I mean, I've been critical of the police state, not of police themselves, but of the political directive of all this. But just as a snapshot of the Secret Service with, like, tears in their eyes and stuff talking to me, I was like, what do they know? And they're just like, you're dead on. Keep it up. You know, pray for this country. They seem totally freaked out by what they know. And of course, they won't tell me all of it. Just so someone asked what you think that means, Mr. Hagmann. HagmannandHagmann.com. This guy was way ahead of his time. We're going to open the phones up for your calls. And Joe Biggs has breaking news coming up as well. Obviously, when you talk to different sources, it's dangerous for the source to be giving you info. They don't try to give you any classified info or, you know, stuff protected by privacy rights or things like that. It's more like, go read what this guy wrote in this article. That's dead on. Or what you're saying's right on. You need to look into more of this. But now it's getting to the point of people are in meetings running security and they are hearing unbelievable plots being hatched against Trump. stuff where people got to speak out. Unbelievable plans to, like, stage an attack on Hillary to blame it on Trump. And then once they've done that, they make Trump look bad. Then they can go after Trump. I mean, this is the kind of stuff that was going on in World War II, like in 1944 in Germany, when folks were not knowing what to do about Hitler. When, it's not that the government's perfect. It's certainly not. The special interests are what are really bad, the globalists. But the people in the government have now been forced to the point of where they're realizing, oh my gosh, the patriots that warned about this world government are right. I mean, George Soros' emails are out. The DNC emails are out. There's tens of thousands of them. Within days of them being out, we've already gotten into the emails. They're up on Infowars.com, DrudgeReport.com, from the Daily Caller and others that have dug them up, saying, we're going to bring in the migrants and get a bunch of government money to take care of them and then use them as political weapons and make it the new normal and merge the Middle East with Europe and take over the U.S. and use the new immigrant groups as our political voting block to control everything and call everybody racist and don't go along with it. I mean, this is a criminal conspiracy, and we have the diary. It's open and shut. It's open and shut. Going back to Mr. Hagmann in a moment, we are running a special on one of our top nutraceuticals that is just really an old apothecary recipe. Every major plant, derivative, herb that's known to clean out the body and flush out parasites. It's living defense. It sells out for 6 months a lot of times because we can't get to so many ingredients. You can't get them all totally clean and have them at California levels, where, you know, it can't have as much lead as the air has in it. So it's a really clean product. All our products are, because they go to the highest standards. Or we couldn't sell them in places like California. That's why it sells out so often. It's a very popular product. I think it'll only be sold out a month this time. I'm still discounting at 20%, even though it's about to sell out. InfoWarsLife.com. InfoWarsStore.com is the umbrella site. Armageddon is a $5 million budget film produced by Chuck Norris's son, the great patriot, Mike Norris. Gary Haven funded it, and it exposes a fictional New World Order takeover here in the United States. You get one copy for $19.95, get a second copy for $19.95, $39.90, and get two of my films free, Matrix of Evil and Fall of the Republic. And it's great to have these in your archive, great to donate them to the local library, great to support this type of work, and the profit we make obviously funds this operation that you see having such a giant effect. So thank you for your support, your prayers. Thanks for shopping with the good guys at InfoWarsStore.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139. I want to thank all the PrisonPlanet.tv nightly news members, but I also want to just thank all of you that put up with me a lot of the time and that get the video links, the audio links, the different articles, and that you post them and you spread them, because I'm risking my life doing this, and I'm not doing this to lose. I know history, and getting back to the point I asked before the break, Mr. Hagmann, who's a wise man, the mainstream globalist media was there, and they wrote about it in scores of publications. I could care less about having the super elite beyond backstage passes to the RNC if it was to go see a George Herbert Walker Bush or a Mitt Romney. But the fact that the Trump people gave us passes that, I mean, literally maybe 100 people had, it was in Newsweek, you name it, Jones, you know, the controversy had, like, you know, the super level passes, the ace of spades. Oh my God, this is, it portends how evil Trump is. Absolutely, it portends how horrible Trump is to you and your globalist agenda. And it shows how fast we can take this country back once people get it and once we have leadership. Because I'm here to tell you, they want us to have a war with the police because on average, the police are more awake than the general public. They want us to have a civil war with the military because they want to take out their enemies at the same time. Just like Hillary got caught in the emails confirming what the Chicago police told us and others. They funded people dressed up like Bernie supporters to attack Trump supporters. That way you blame Trump for violence and Bernie, who looks good. It's elementary, my dear Watson. But we've caught them. We've caught them, and people understand this now, and it's really scaring them. It's really upsetting them, and it shows that they want to have a civil war in this country where you randomly shoot cops in the back of the head, some weird leftist communist civil war. It's not a communist takeover, but it's communism they use at the grassroots, just like Milwaukee. It was communists doing that. That's how the globalists intend to rob us, is playing us off against each other. Instead, the feds went in 30 years ago and funded militias because they knew it was a constitutional movement. I'm going to get Hagman's take on this. Some of them to be violent, to put out bad rhetoric against police and local government, because those were natural allies for the police and military. It was constitutional. To brand militia as bad. See, it's all this branding. Well, here's the deal. I'm not going to be branded as if I want to kill cops. I'm not going to be branded that I'm out to blow things up. That's the weathermen. That's the people that advise Obama. That's all of their people. That's, you know, the guy pledging his book to Lucifer, Rules for Radicals, all the rest of this garbage. These people mean business, folks. They have a plan. We know their plan. And so when I get the emails, see the comments, oh, you're just a cop worshiper, blah, blah, blah. That's ridiculous. I'm for good police, just like I'm for good judges or good school teachers or good farmers or good, you know, engineers. I judge people individually, and I want my republic, and I can see a foreign outside globalist move to overthrow our country, and I can see them do it in other nations, and I'm resisting it because I'm an American and this is my republic. And they call Russia draconian for kicking the George Soros foundations out of their country and kicking his people out of the country when they catch him landing in the nation. When Soros admits he's trying to overthrow Russia right now. I'm surprised Russia isn't arresting those people that fly in. Those are foreign corporate agents. See, we always think of Russian agents or American agents or Chinese agents, and that goes on. But corporations and global banks have their own intelligence agencies, and they're playing us off against each other. Now, I'm ranting. I'm giving you the floor, Mr. Hagman. Get into other facets of this. Do you think I'm right about how awake the police and military are? And Black Lives Matter, what are they going to try running this up to the election? Where do we go from here?
Well, you know, though, I think you're 100% accurate, everything that you've said. And the more I see and the more I talk to my police sources, especially on the local level, the county level, the state level as well, they're sick and tired of being used as pawns in the game, in the larger game here, the political game that we see taking place in the United States. Now, having said that, I've got to just reaffirm the Saul Alinsky playbook that you talked about, Rules for Radicals. You know, May 2nd, 1969, Hillary Diane Rodham Clinton wrote her senior thesis on that Rules for Radicals, on Saul Alinsky's ideological concept of just taking, burning everything down. And she's implementing that or attempting to.
And she pen-palled him.
Yeah, very much. Yes, yes. And of course, the Clark Piven strategy that we've seen, which pigtails onto or hooks onto the Keynesian economics that we're seeing here in the United States. All of this combined is working toward the destruction of our constitutional republic, which you have done much to expose and to restore and to maintain the constitutional republic, which is what we're attempting to do as well. So having said all of that, you're dead on accurate with respect to what's taking place. I do believe that 100%. Now, the where we're at right now, I do believe, is a situation where they are going to pull something, and this is based on my the weight of my sources as well. They're going to do something ahead of the elections in November to ensure, at least in their mind, to ensure the their plans for world domination and domination of the West, and specifically the United States, goes forward. Whether that means sacrificing Hillary, as much as that sounds incredible, if they've got to move Hillary out of the way a tad, knowing that she'll never go to jail for any of this, but certainly might be taken out of the game, they may do that if they or whatever the case might be. But what we're seeing here is political theater to cover the actions of the globalists here in the United States. So you're 100% accurate, and yes, I will say the police, and I loved what you said, because I get a lot of email as well saying I'm a police officer in Fredericks or Maryland or whatever. Give my best to Alex when you talk to him tomorrow. So, you know, we get a lot of these as well. So the rank and file of the police want to do the right thing. They're being federalized at the top. They understand what's going on, but the majority of the people who are actually on the streets having guns pointed at them are in fact supporters of yours and ours, and the supporters of the people that just the average person. So, and they see that everyone's being played one against the other. They're seeing this artificially created, orchestrated racial tension. This racial tension would not exist without Obama, Clinton, the globalists, and the communist influence, as you stated earlier.
What else is on the radar?
Well, the economic, again, the petrodollar is really a big thing. That's what Russia did and the agreement with Iran, and now Turkey switching sides from NATO to Russia, more of a Russia-China alliance, snubbing the U.S. out of this, using anything but the U.S. dollar. That really has put us on the ropes. And the situation in Syria, the situation in Crimea, Ukraine, all of this combined is these are all global chess moves by the globalists. But again, now everything that happens here in the United States, in particular the elections, who's going to be the next U.S. president, of course, we have to look at all of this. We have to look at the elections, I should say, against that backdrop, against the backdrop of what's taking place globally, because everything is on a global level, and what happens on a local, state, and federal level, of course, is a microcosm of the globalist agenda.
Doug Hagman of HagmanandHagman.com. Looking at this, and I want to have Joe Biggs pop in here with some breaking news. He's in Milwaukee right now covering the situation up there. We see these times historically when all these major political realignments happen, where all these wars happen, where sides start flipping sides. Most historians agree with us that we're at the most critical juncture in history and that we see similar things that happened before World War I and World War II, and that the world is hurtling towards major economic collapse and warfare. And then meanwhile, we have Soros and others trying to stir up collapses all over the place to consolidate control. Do you think these people are crazy enough to go ahead with this plan, even though it looks like they're not in a good position?
Sure. I have no doubt in my mind. These people, as you had said, you had described the information you got received from your sources, where there's security. These people are openly talking about their criminality, their criminal plans, the cabals of lawlessness. I mean, look at the lawlessness that we're seeing today here in this country, where you can't get a conviction or even interest in opening an investigation when there's evidence. And I'm
look
convinced,
at Hillary. It's just everywhere.
Yeah.
That's why they're so arrogant, because they know they have the Justice Department.
Right. But they don't want to lose that, and they can see losing that. They can see the writing on the wall. That's why they're pitching the polls. They're saying, oh well, Donald Trump is behind, and they're going to do whatever they can to negate.
So this is all or nothing on both sides. I mean, this is it.
To me, based on everything I've heard, Alex, this is for all the marbles, as I like to say. This is the final throes for this domination. And people say, well, that's kind of, oh man, that's, don't say that, because that's causing fear. No, I mean, I think it's just reality. I think that now is the hinge moment.
When the Secret Service are out in the middle of the cameras and the lights and everywhere, shaking my hand and stuff, I mean, they've never been like that. You know that they don't care anymore.
That's right.
And of course, I'm told that across agencies, people are ready for them to steal the election. They're ready for the globalists to make their next move. And the military and police are just ready now. I think that the establishment's really miscalculated. I think it's moved the point. People don't care anymore. And they took everybody's restraint for weakness, Doug.
Yeah, and that's right. Our silence for apathy, our tolerance for acceptance. I think that they're seeing now that they've miscalculated, perhaps. And another area of concern that I have, I'm just going to toss this out there too. And you wrote about this on your website, Infowars.com, is the ISIS presence in Mexico. Well, according to my sources, the importation of ISIS elements into the United States has been going at full speed for the last 3 years.
And by the way, let's cover that now, because I'm getting Joe Biggs on about our source and more information on Hillary's health from the Secret Service. But since you mentioned that, we're about to go to break in a moment. I want to come back with that, Mr. Hagman. Biggs went down there off the Judicial Watch memos and confirmed the mosque, confirmed the Islamists going on. The FBI said no one even dares go in that area. It's the most dangerous area in Mexico. The movie Sicario is basically about that area, you know, where there's firefights and tracers every night. The FBI met with Biggs on record at the airport and said, you know, thank you for information. And then basically debriefed him and said, yes, we know this is going on. It's very credible, but we're basically not allowed to talk about it. So let's bring Joe Biggs in to briefly talk about that, from Milwaukee. He's on the phone right now. He'll be joining us on video later. Joe Biggs. Or there is, we have video now. Go ahead, Joe.
Joe Biggs here with Infowars.com. We're actually standing right across from where the BP station that was burnt down, much like what we saw in Ferguson, Missouri, after those riots. Over to my right, we have a whole bunch of people trying to bring joy to the area. A lot of people are coming out trying to raise money, help out the community, get a lot of these kids off the street and involved in something else. But I heard you mentioning about the jihadi camp in Mexico. Yeah, that's something we started covering over a year ago. We had these reports from Judicial Watch that said that there was possibly an ISIS base operating in the Anapra area. Now, that is just south of El Paso, Texas. You cross over into Ciudad Juarez, and then you head west about 10 miles into a town called Anapra. And it's mostly run by cartels. And we initially came out with our reports. We were saying that there's a good possibility that cartels could be helping out these ISIS jihadis and smuggling them across the border because they're very familiar with that area. And people mocked us and said that, no, there's no way that cartels would help out. Now we have ISIS guys who've been captured here in the U.S. who have actually come out and said, yes, they have brothers down there in Mexico that are waiting, and they're using the cartels to smuggle these guys in, and they're waiting to carry out attacks in Arizona and in Texas.
And the question is, why is the Border Patrol being ordered to stand down? Why wouldn't they at least stop ISIS-type people? It just seems like a total disregard and just don't care, just like the diseases coming across. Why not test them and treat people for TB and then let them in? Why just let them come in with TB? Joe Biggs, we'll answer that later. I want to come back with you and Mr. Hagmann and get into more intel you got last night from our pipeline to the Secret Service on Hillary's health. We'll be back. I'm Alex Jones. Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com are our main sites. Stay with us. But the good news is the word is spreading to really dizzying levels now. I would call this the Great Awakening right now. Now, we still face incredible challenges, and this is our darkest hour. But through this storm, I can see the sun ahead. Mr. Hagmann will be with us 20 minutes, 30 minutes the next hour. We're going to open the phones up. Then my reporters are going to pop back in from Milwaukee after that. But Biggs, notice we broke the big leak news on Sunday with the Secret Service. And of course, people know we've got a lot of big leaks over the years. We've broken thousands of big stories, hundreds of number one stories. We're in the top 100 of news websites in the world. Drudge is number one. We reach 28 million people a week. The media knows it's real. Or they would have tried to debunk it. Total silence on that bombshell, Joe Biggs.
Well, some of the new revelations that I've received over the last 24 hours from my contact within the Secret Service, he pretty much laid out the fact that if you look at these other high-vis, what I mean by that is a high-visibility candidate, you know, politician, a diplomat, someone like that, when they move in motorcades, they usually have to set aside a certain amount of police officers, i.e. on motorcycles and in vehicles when they go to a certain city. So when Hillary Clinton comes into, say, Philadelphia like she did today, they're supposed to set aside two squad cars and a number of motorcycles that can pull ahead, stop the traffic at those four ways to allow that motorcade to zip through as fast as possible. But due to her falling health or failing health, she's not able to go through all that high-speed process. And what they're doing is they're telling these police officers to stand down. So now you have a motorcade with a lot of high-ranking people within our government, and you have Secret Services that don't have that protection, and now they have to stop at each red light, which is putting lives in danger in case someone wants to attack her or commit some kind of crime against her. That's putting lives in danger because she can't handle the lights going by. So that's something that's very dangerous.
And to be clear, they're not giving us secret medical information. They're not giving us documents. They're just pointing out things that we can then observe that are public knowledge.
Yeah, so I also have a guy that's going to be in Philadelphia today, and then there's going to be another rally coming up in Cleveland, I believe, where I'm going to have some guys that are going to try to catch her motorcade and get that footage to show us how there's a stand down of the police to help get those people to and from there.
Also show the handicap ramps that lower down from the bottom of the vehicle.
Yeah, exactly.
So you got other information from another military source that concurs with my sources about other stuff that's so unbelievable. We're going to just have to develop that and cover that when you get back.
Okay.
But, let me know when you want to go to that. Other tidbits, Joe Biggs.
Well, the interesting thing is if we take a step back and look at the broader picture of what's going on, you have these leaks coming out. It's almost like there's this internal coup that's now been created almost by this new patriot movement. The fact that Donald Trump has his popular vote.
I'd call it counter coup.
Well, yeah, but what it is, though, it's the fact that there's so many people that have been working in the government that felt like they've had no voice. They felt like they haven't had an opportunity to expose corruption. I think people see light knowing that if Donald Trump gets elected, we can get out these bad people. And that's why you see these revelations. That's why you see these people coming out with this information, these hacks and things like that. I think it's good, and it's scaring the elite. And that's why when I get back to Austin, you and I are going to talk about a lot of this information that we've both gotten, and it's really going to open up a lot of eyes and expose and show.
That's right. What happens is the Secret Service and others see us with the top link over the weekend on Drudge, and they see that we're willing to put stuff out. And that's why we got the Homeland Security documents 7 years ago that say veterans and gun owners are the number one enemy. And by the way, Joe, you're technically right. The government is, you know, Clinton and, you know, or Obama right now. So we'd say it's a coup because they're not following them. But these are hijackers, so I call it a counter coup. But you're absolutely right. We were in the middle of the resistance against the foreign occupation. It's happening, people. It's happening. But the enemy will strike back. Get ready. I'm going to come back to Joe, finish up, and then to Mr. Hagman and your phone calls. America is a great jewel hijacked by globalists. They've used our great nation's treasure and ingenuity and will to build a planetary government. Now they wish to shut down what's left of the Republic and enslave us once and for all. And I got news for them. We've only begun to fight. And all over Europe and all over the world, people are seceding. They're pulling out. They're saying no. Globalism is in great crisis. I know they bought off the churches the last 200 years and told everybody that, you know, it's the end of the world and evil can't be beaten. But truth is, evil will be beaten until it's God's time to let it out of the box one more time. Going back to Mr. Hagman, he's going to stay with us the rest of the hour to take your phone calls. Our reporters are going to be popping in at the bottom of the hour. But just hearing what Joe Biggs was saying, I'm going to get a final comment from him. But Doug, really, he crystallized it. This is a coup, a counter coup, whatever you want to call it. This is called the death throes of the Republic. Well, I don't think it's that. I think it's the reawakening of the sleeping giant to know that the most awake, I cannot hammer this enough, the most awake people are the police, are the military, that the globalists count on to enforce all this. And the fact that they've been persecuting them to try to intimidate them into line, they miscalculated like Tokyo Rose. The intimidation didn't work. It only pissed them off. And so they've just been calculating the best way to stand up against this. Is that a fair way to say it?
Yeah, I think so. And I think neither one is really mutually exclusive. I think that we're seeing a coup, the counter coup, and perhaps some of this, to some extent, Alex, maybe it was, there was a plan, much like Cloward Piven, perhaps, to overwhelm the system. You know, we're seeing a lot of assets here domestically being sent out to quell the riots, the disturbances that are orchestrated on the other side.
Oh, they're so, clearly trying to bankrupt things.
Yeah,
and then federalize.
Absolutely.
They admit that.
Yeah, yeah. So, yeah, I mean, I think in general, yeah, you're absolutely 100% correct. And I'm amazed at the information that you're developing that seems to substantiate what we're getting as well. So it does seem like there's this awakening taking place, and I hope it continues. But what do they have? What are they going to counter with, I suppose, is my question.
That's the big question. We're going to talk about that after the break. Joe Biggs, what do you think they're going to try to counter with?
Well, it's the Force Awakens. Think about this. We have this force that has been the government, and you had this dark side that's dominated for so long, and now we have this potential presidential candidate that can really come out and shine through, and a lot of these people are now the light side of the force is coming out and seeing this, and they're starting to expose a lot of things. They're coming out. The email I got last night, it's from Homeland Security, OGA, all these different entities emailed me last night with different information confirming what it is we've been talking about the past few days. There's a great awakening happening, and everyone is now seeing that there's finally a chance that they can come out without being persecuted. They have a voice now.
Everybody has to move at once, then they can't get us all.
Yes, we need to come out. We need to come out with this information.
Mass wave information warfare attacks.
Roger that.
Well, hey, I want to salute the folks that hacked the Democrats. They're criminals. I want to salute the folks that hacked Soros. I mean, and listen, this is only the beginning. This is only the beginning, isn't it, Joe?
Oh, this is only the beginning. The information I'm getting every day, I'm getting data dumps, people sending me stuff, just waves of information coming through. Now that we've come out with this information on Sunday about Hillary Clinton with the Secret Service, more and more departments, more and more people I know are reaching out with information. They want this to come to an end. Most people do not want Hillary Clinton. That's like in the 90 percentile. Everyone wants to see patriotism thrive. They want to have freedom. And we do not need another Clinton in the White House.
We got a weirdo Nazi collaborator trying to get people to go out and burn stuff and shoot police. I mean, give me a break. All right, Joe Biggs, we'll talk to you and the rest of the crew. We'll talk to Rob Dew and Jakari Jackson. Jakari first,
We got the Trump rally tonight, too, at 7:30. That's going to be in West Bend, just above Milwaukee. So we'll be there tonight covering that as well.
Great goods. We'll have some live coverage on the nightly news. Great job, crew. We'll talk to you in 30 minutes. All right, Jakari Jackson, coming up in 30 minutes. We're going to take your phone calls and talk to Doug Hagman straight ahead. He's going to ride shotgun with us and co-host for the rest of the hour. Then Paul Joseph Watson from London, England, always a firebrand of key intel. He'll be joining us. Toll-free number to join us, 800-259-9231, 800-259-9231. What do you think about what we're talking about? Do you agree? Do you disagree? Stay with us. Hour number three, Paul Watson. Another fresh horse in the fight comes in. At the start of the next hour from London, England, we have the founder of the Northeast Intelligence Network, co-host of Hagman & Hagman, Doug Hagman, our guest, a guy who, I mean, his sources back before any of this even started, he laid out the whole battle plan from his FBI and DHS sources. And I've just got to tell you that I don't lionize our government, our federal government, and the things it does. I think the DEA has been caught doing horribly unconstitutional things, so have other agencies. But this is our country. We have a bunch of multinational globalists in the middle of it trying to bring it down. So we can reform stuff later. We can fight with each other later as Americans. We're not going to have a bunch of foreign globalist weirdos like George Soros in here playing us off against each other like we're a bunch of idiots. I think that's the message we got to put out here. And the people that don't get that, even some libertarians and conservatives that see the excesses of government and police and see police as the representation of government, celebrating cops being shot in the back of the head, and I do see that sentiment out there, is the stuff collapses are made of. And the type of people that talk like that, I guarantee, are the ones that when the rubber meets the road aren't going to raise a rifle up to defend their family or this republic. I'm doing everything I can to fix things peacefully. I'm doing everything I can so people know who the real enemies are in this country, so they don't kick off a civil war and then we all kill each other and do the globalist job for them. I'm going to explain this one more time and go back to our guests and the calls. The microcosm of the confirmed emails that Hillary, and when we got this from sources, I was like, she's that bold? And then it turned out to be true. They had buses coming in, paid for by Move On and other groups, that's Soros, with Bernie Sanders shirts on, given a lunch and like $50, depending on which city it was. They put them up in hotels to attack Trump people and then to say Trump was at fault and Bernie was at fault. That is a microcosm of the civil war they want to start in this country with, between citizens and local government. It's stupid. And it's them playing their enemies off against each other. The globalists are against this country. They want to bankrupt it because they can't compete with it. We're under scientific military attack. New emails are out showing Soros directing the UN and Peter Sutherland how to flood Europe and use it as a political force to bring down the nations. I can't exaggerate enough to describe how bad this is, okay? Because reality is much bigger than what I can say. But we're up against cold-blooded evil. So, are there a lot of issues, a lot of problems in this country? Absolutely. We'll fix those problems after we've defeated the New World Order. Because it's the big enemy that wants you poor. I'll guarantee you, your local government, if it's not New World Order run, some of them are, it wants you to be prosperous and successful. For all our problems, Americans like to be successful. And I'm not going to sit here and watch them blow this country's engine, because they've almost done it. Mr. Hagman, other points, the awakening, tricks they may pull, and then I want to go to phone calls, my friend. Hagman and Hagman.com, thanks for joining us.
You know, thanks so much for having me, Alex. I think you just really summarized it very eloquently. What we're seeing right now is the plans that have gone awry. You know, the globalists can make the plans. They have their objectives. We laid them out back in 2008, 2007, 2008, and again in 2011 into 2012. The 2012 election went to Obama. So, of course, there was no necessity at that point to really pull the grenade pin on anything of detriment, you know, to burn the house down back then. But now we're facing an entirely different, they're facing an entirely different scenario with a lot more people who are awake. And I think this is a race right now. It's an information race as well as a war. The more information that gets out there, the more people are saying, wait a minute, there's something wrong here. We know there's something wrong. But then, of course, Alex, you're going to have people, and I think we see it, the people that you could have Hillary sacrificing children on the White House lawn, and they would find a way to spin it or to approve it or to whatever, to cover it up. But having said all of that, I think right now, today, and in the days, weeks, and months ahead, I think we're looking at a very volatile situation domestically and globally. And I think it's incumbent upon us as truth tellers and truth seekers as well to get the information out there to inform as many people as possible and to be very alert and aware of what could happen and to really expect the unexpected. As I said earlier, I think a lot of times, and I look back in my investigative career, anytime I've ever had a problem, it usually comes from someplace I never thought it would come from. You know, it blindsided me, never saw it coming. So I think we have to kind of watch that as well. You know, watch what we're not seeing, perhaps, what we don't really expect. And I think that's our greatest.
They could release some type of bioweapon.
Who knows? Yeah, yeah.
They could. Really, yeah. There's anything they could do.
Yeah, and I do believe, Alex. I think that the fact that you've got these tens of thousands of Muslims coming into this country to balkanize America, to water down our culture, our language, our borders, as Michael Savage says, to really take over, change change the makeup of our country. I think is part and parcel to this, but the ISIS factor as well. They're not finished with ISIS. They're not finished weaponizing.
Well, obviously, they brought in 5 million there. It's probably millions here. They're covering up, saying it's tens of thousands. We know that's not true. It's tens of thousands in Austin, Texas alone. How do they think they're going to get away with more jihad attacks than ever before when they're the ones that brought them in, and then they take our rights as a counter to that? I mean, clearly, they've got some big plan for forcing all the jihadis in. Soros talks about political opportunities. What does he mean by that in this new email?
Great question. Interesting concept. The opportunity. I think anytime that there is a problem, a crisis, a situation that is, well, like the who said it, Rahm Emanuel, never let a crisis go to waste. I think anytime that we have or we're faced, or the country that is faced with a situation that is problematic, I think that it could be spun into something different. For example, we've got this massive problem with Islam in terms of the attacks over in Europe. If that happens here, there's going to be pushback. Well, how do you handle that pushback? You don't go after the anti-Islamic speech. You go after the entire religious speech. So you neutralize Christians, for example, in that case. So any event, whether it's a shooting or a beheading or an attack.
That's the admitted plan. No, I mean, they admit in Europe, they just ban all free speech, period.
And there you go. So I believe that's the written implementation, the written plans of the implementation of that larger, again, think bigger.
Well, they've admitted global government is in trouble, from the Washington Post to the Financial Times of London. And folks, we should do a whole show asking listeners, what type of curveballs could they throw? What type of tricks do they have up their sleeves? That is a really great point. And I'll tell listeners this. You with your smartphone, or you with a camera, wherever you're at, videotape everything when there's a terror attack. Videotape everything when there's something weird going on. Get it out on the internet, and citizen analysts, will look at that and keep catching them, because the establishment is scared at how much humet just regular people have, how much human intelligence is out there. Folks, you're just as effective as anybody in history when you decide to take action. And I'm telling you, because I'm not the smartest guy around, and I've done a lot 21 years on air. Take action, know what we're facing, realize what's going on, reach out to people, and we're going to defeat this new world order. Let's go ahead and go to some phone calls here. Who's been holding the longest? Let me say Islamic rule in USA, DNC leaks. Let's go ahead. Voter fraud, cell phone photos of polls. Trump and Hillary. Who should I go to first? Who's been holding the longest here? Let's go ahead and talk to Ed in Arizona. You're on the air with the founder of the Northeast Intelligence Network, Mr. Hagmann. Go ahead.
Thank you, sir. Please just give me a minute. I'll be very brief. 100% way to end voter fraud. Everyone take your cell phone into the privacy of the voting booth. Take a photo of your vote for Trump. Post it to a website with your zip code. You could create a simple website. Also, those vote protector people. We can actually change the entire paradigm.
Sure. It's just organizing, coordinating all those people. The bigger thing is exit pollers in the 10 battleground states. That's what Trump's doing. But yes.
Well, yes, that will work. Also, it would be verifiable. It would be instant. And there, if you could just get this pushed out, maybe the Drudge could carry it. If you get enough people to do that, it's instant, verifiable with a zip code and a photo. I think it would change the entire paradigm of exit polling.
There's a lot of collation data stuff there and regionalization and tracking and verification. And then you'd have security issues and ID issues and integration issues and re-up feed collation issues. But point is, we need exit polls. Go ahead.
Oh, yes, I know. But I'm just saying, if there's zip codes attached to just a photo of a vote, and there's always those little codes on each photo, but I also want Trump to think big ideas of getting us back to the moon, back missions to Mars. And I'm sick of people referring to America's heartland as the Rust Belt. That's a pejorative against our country. I think Trump should really take offense to that. I personally do. And they should be renowned as America's industrial heartland again, instead of just being referred to as the Rust Belt. And they act like that's
No, I hear you. I hear you, Ed. I appreciate your call. Really good points. I'm not poo-pooing what you said. It's just actually trying to organize that, and then everybody takes a photo and sends it to a site with a zip code. Then how do you visually scan that and then collate all those? I mean, Mr. Hagmann?
Yeah, I'm not sure. Wow. Anything digital, in my view, right now could be manipulated, and that certainly could be corrupted. We definitely need to have some sort of verification.
We need exit polls, and we need poll watchers there to make sure we don't have people voting repeatedly.
Yep, I agree.
I've talked to the top election fraud experts. That's what needs to be done. I'm not poo-pooing what the caller's saying. He's going the right direction raising this problem.
Well, it goes back to, you know, the judges, ID for voting. Come on. I mean, how simple is that one issue?
The Democrats in a bunch of states are trying to pass laws to let illegals vote.
Sure. And vote early and often for the illegals. Absolutely.
They have illegals now doing recruiting drives. And again, I can't go to other countries and do that. I'm not thinking, why do you hate these people? I don't hate them. It's just that it's organized crime. God, Lord. Here, let's go ahead and take another call. Let's talk to Michael in Tennessee. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Hey, how you doing, Alex?
Good, brother.
First of all, I just wanted to address Mr. Hagmann. He was talking earlier about Hillary executing kids on the front lawn of the White House and that they would find a way to make it okay for her. Why not just call that extreme late-term abortion?
Actually, we've gone out on the street in California and Austin and told liberals that Hillary or Obama wanted to kill kids up to three, and they agree with it and say it is late-term post-birth abortion, so that's actually not a joke. And Islamic State, when they were cutting little kids' heads off and a video came out, they said it was an accident. So she would just have to say it was an accident, and then it would be okay.
Oh, of course. You know, somebody told somebody, and that somebody disappears and gets killed, and it's all an accident.
But see, no matter what, no matter how extreme you say, they're already doing it.
Of course. Another thing I wanted to bring up real quick, I was doing some reading earlier on Wikipedia under New World Order, and believe it or not, they mention Alex Jones not as a liberator of truth, but as a right-wing agitator. And I just find that amazing that they take people who are giving the people what they deserve, the truth, and forming.
Where was this?
If you go on Wikipedia on New World Order and go down to where it says modern conspiracy theories, it labels you as a right-wing
agitator.
Yeah,
you know, somebody ought to do a piece on that because the world government has been announced. I mean, the Pope's calling for it. End of borders, global taxes. We should be getting awards for, you know, talking about it 20 years ago or Ron Paul 30 years ago or Ronald Reagan 50 years ago. We don't. We get ridiculed because we were right, Doug.
Yeah. I mean, Gary Allen, in his book, None Dare Call a Conspiracy, which you've got on your website, absolutely. I mean, this has been out there for a long time. And I find it really interesting. Now people are developing some level of, I don't know, guts, I guess. You know, now that the ice has been broken, to come out and say, okay, I guess you guys were right, meaning you were right when you were talking about
this. Well, you
too,
brother. I mean, hell, it was like, I was like 3 years old and had my dad sitting around the coffee table talking about this. So I'm certainly not, I'm a late comer. Go ahead.
No, it's just, it's interesting to see how this is all really developing and playing out. And it's interesting to see how each one of us, and I really believe this, anyone that's listening to this program or watching this program, you've got the opportunity to change the course of history. And if we don't do something right now, I don't believe we're going to have another chance at it. We have one chance, and the chance is now, and we need to take action. We need to think not of ourselves, but of our children and of the legacy which we're going to leave behind. That's just my personal view.
Absolutely. And look, Hillary Clinton has got over $100 million the last 2 years alone to her foundation from Gulf states. That's what we know of. That throw homosexuals off buildings, that chop women's heads off if they talk back to their husband. And then I got to be lectured how I'm against a woman because I don't like Hillary. It has nothing to do with what's going on between her legs. She's a monster. And I'm just so sick of being told I'm sexist or racist when really all I'm guilty of in my life is spoiling everybody around me. I'm so sick of it.
Exactly. You know, and I think we're going to see ties too, now that you mentioned this, and we're going to see, as these emails become even more prolific, exposed, you're going to see ties where the Saudis, really, Hillary Clinton has been on the payroll of the Saudis. She abused her position at the State Department, as you write and point out. She has all of her aides, Huma Abedin, Cheryl Mills. You're going to see all this lawlessness, but being paid for by foreign entities that include but are not limited to Saudi Arabia.
Totally illegal if you or I did it.
Right. Oh, yeah, exactly. We'd be in a prison.
We should be. Yeah. And you know, that's what's crazy. And I mean, not getting into the cops' mind, but let's look at their position for a while. And I know they're the front of the state, kind of the problem. We let the state become this. But I'm out there going to a Black Lives Matter communist event. Cops had just been shot days before. Cops, on average, don't get shot that often, but it's still a dangerous job. But what is dangerous is going to a Black Lives Matter rally. And imagine I'm the main target there. I go and I do it. And it just put me in the mindset for like 30 minutes of being a cop at one of those rallies where you're out there in the middle of a square. Anybody can shoot you. And so all I'm saying is at least have a little bit of empathy. And if we have empathy for the police, then they're going to listen to us and we can reform what's happening when bad politicians are trying to twist the police. That's why they don't want us to get along with the police. They don't want the citizens to be interfacing with other citizens.
Right. And you know, you're going to have bad apples in every group and every demographic.
Yeah, there are plenty of dirty cops.
Yeah. But what you're saying, and again, I'm right there with you on this. We have to look at how we are all of us are being gamed by these globalists, how they're managing, well, mapping and managing the human domain. Where have we heard that before? As an aside, you know, this Tavistockian influence over our language, over what we say, over this is not freedom.
Our elite is allied with the most scumbag communist and radical Muslims you can imagine. They're bad people. We want a change of management. It's our country, and you better back off New World Order. Let's go ahead and talk to Kristen in California. She says she's a poll worker on voting. Kristen, go ahead.
Hi, Alex. I was a poll worker in the California June primary, and I estimate that 50 to 60% of voters voluntarily showed their ID when they came up to vote so we could look them up on the roster. We didn't ask, and we couldn't by law, and people don't mind showing ID, and I am in the most liberal area of California you can imagine, and people still don't mind showing ID.
Sure. What do you make of Stanford Research Institute finding that Bernie Sanders was the winner and was defrauded? That's the Hill newspaper and even Reuters.
We certainly saw a lot more Bernie stickers out here and Bernie signage in California than Hillary stuff, I'll tell you that.
Wow. Other points you'd like to make as a poll worker?
I think it's important for people to go out there and volunteer. It's a long day, but it's worth it, and you get to see who comes in. You get to watch your neighbors, and you get to watch the poll workers, too, and also the poll watchers. A lot of liberal groups send in their people and demand to see their roster every hour we update, and they, you know, get real snarky about it. But we need to have conservative, good people in there doing that work, too. Good public service.
It certainly is. Well, I've been a poll watcher myself. I've been an exit poller. I haven't done it in probably 18 years, but I'm going to do it again this year. We're going to be here covering it live, and I intend to go out myself. I'm going to pick a precinct, and Texas is key because it's probably, but they're even saying Texas is going to go Hillary, Georgia, Utah. Who believes any of this? I mean, these polls are completely backwards. I think California is even in play for Trump, or do you think otherwise? What are you seeing, Kristen?
Well, it seems to me that California's going to go for Hillary and that the Trump people are embarrassed and afraid to even pronounce it. There are no Trump signs around here. People are afraid that they're going to get vandalized. I wouldn't put one on my lawn. No way. You know, they'll trash my house. So
that's been happening.
Tolerance.
That's been happening.
Yeah. I don't want to get involved in that, but, you know, Trump is the better of the two. Hillary, no way. Can't have it. Don't do it. A no vote is a Hillary vote. So people, go vote Trump.
Absolutely. People voting for Green Party or Gary Johnson. And I've been a big libertarian. I've been about building third parties. But I've interviewed Gary Johnson like 15 years ago. Different guy. And, man, the times he's been around the last few times, they asked, hey, you want Gary Johnson on? Even before he ran for president. And I went, no, I don't want him on. Because he'd been here in studio. And I'm like, hey, man. He's just like, thank you, Alex. Good to speak. And just like a robot. And I think Gary Johnson has gone over to the dark side. What do you think? What do you think about voting third party, Doug Hagman?
No, you know, in a perfect world, in a perfect society, well, even in a non-representative republic where there's no electoral college, yeah, maybe in a democracy, but we're not in a democracy. We're in a representative republic. The rules are different. So you're talking about viability, and I think that any other vote outside of what we have been given, the cards that we've been given to play, would be a mistake. So you're either
absolutely. When you got two bad candidates sometimes for president, you know, sure, go third party to build a third party. And I've helped build the Libertarian Party. I mean, I've really helped them. Now I see them just turned over to like some kind of globalist organization. I'm really ashamed of the Libertarian Party right now, Doug.
Oh, yeah, I agree.
I mean, it's just, I mean, TPP, some unelected secret corporate thing. Oh, it's free market. No, it's not free market. Corporations can conquer you just as fast as government, Gary Johnson. Maybe I should get Gary Johnson on. I'll tear the living hell out of him. I mean, I am sick of him, man. He's there to make sure Hillary gets in. We're going to come back with more of your calls. Our reporters on the ground at Doug Hagman. I'm Alex Jones, InfoWars.com. I was like 7 years old, and I was reading the Star Wars trilogy in one paperback that my dad, you know, had got episode 4, 5, and 6. So I was reading adult science fiction and stuff when I was 7, 8 years old. Really good reader. Wasn't good at spelling or math, but I've been a good reader. I mean, I was reading like a, you know, 8th grade level when I was about 5. And I suddenly started reading history books, and they were just so entertaining. I remember being about 10 years old, my mom's going, you're reading Nietzsche? Do you understand that? And I'm like, not really, but I'm into this. And then I read None Dare Call a Conspiracy, and I already had so much history when I was like 13 years old that everything clicked. And that little book tells you basically everything, how they run it, how the scam operates. It's like a 200-page version of Tragedy and Hope that Quigley wrote from the position of the globalist that's 1,100 pages long. And so I grew up not having some victimhood. It was just kind of like I knew there was a global government being formed in mega banks and that all this was being set up. And I had family that was in different secretive black ops and stuff. But that was just kind of like family that did something secret. I didn't really, you know what they were doing, but then I knew that when I talked to them about stuff and I was like 13, 14, they'd be like, that's exactly right, kid. That's how it all works, and that's who does it. And then I went to college and heard all this anti-American garbage all day and world government being pushed, and I was like, it's happening. I forgot. I knew all this, but I'm living it now. I'm going to fight this. And by the time I was 20 years old, had an Access TV show, by 21, had a radio show, by 23, syndicated to over 20 stations at that time, close to 200 today. And what I want to say to new listeners or people or folks that make jokes at MSNBC, you can sit there and choose sides, but at least be conscious about it. Don't lie to yourselves and say you're not signing on to an evil corporate world government, because that's what this is. And I take it personal that a mega corporate world government's being set up that thinks of me as a slave. I'm not rolling over to it. And that's what Doug Hagman's standing up against, and that's what Ron Paul stands up against, and Donald Trump, and Matt Drudge, and all these other people. But we're just focal points of a larger global movement to want to have local control and self-determination. People say, oh, well, global government's just the next level, like Star Trek. You go from hunter-gatherers to agrarian to city-states to nation-states to empires to regional empires to global governance. But who runs the global governance? It's not like we phase into this over 100 years and it's democratically done. This is done by very anti-human people. I want to go to Ja'Kari Jackson in Milwaukee to talk about this, but Doug Hagman, finishing up, you're going to be riding shotgun with us. When did you start learning about the New World Order?
You know, I was a late start, Alex, unlike yourself. It took me quite a long time, well into my adulthood. I don't think I believed, although I knew what you were talking about, I knew about it. I don't think I really believed it until really right after 9/11. That's how late of a start I got. At least I saw it happen. And I saw, as we were investigating through our network of investigators, the Islamic terrorist websites and such, I saw we kept running into good guys. We kept running into FBI and CIA agents in these chat rooms. And then it clicked, and I thought, oh, wait a minute. When we can't tell who the good guys are from the bad, well, then we've got a problem. And everything that came, everything that you had been talking about and everything that we'd learned or I'd learned or read about, then I realized, okay, now we're being gamed. And I realized how vast and how epic this game is. So I'm a late upstart.
Well, I don't blame people not, you know, wanting to think America's still America, but this is corporate. This is a system we've not faced before. It's not a foreign country. It's a globalist operation. And you think about how the article right here in my stack, how the Communist Party, USA, admittedly, the local police chief is saying, came in to the town, communist group members in Milwaukee to help revolution. And you look at how, you know, one cop shoots another cop, one black cop shoots another black cop. It's clearly not racial. Now some people are saying this cop might be dirty and had a bad background. Who knows? The point is, why does the media then give this all this attention? Why do we cover it? Well, we've got to cover what the media is going to do. It's literally just to divert attention away from the larger political things that are unfolding. And Ja'Kari Jackson is there on the ground in Milwaukee. Tonight they're going to cover a Trump rally in a nearby suburb. And Ja'Kari's been there since last night observing. Thank God things de-escalated last night. What are your observations, Ja'Kari? Because to me, so many times statistically, just like cops killing people is very low, I think overall the civil unrest, if you compare it to the rest of the country, is pretty low. But the media hyping it and saying it's good, that's my concern. What do you think about what's happening?
Well, since we got here last night, things have been very calm. We came last night. I didn't see any National Guard on the street, even though they are in the area prepared to be deployed if necessary. But thus far, if you look around right now, it's a lot of ATF. They're new. Last night, it was mostly the sheriffs and the PD, but the ATF is now out here investigating the scene. And actually, I ran across this interesting article, Alex, where they were talking about the ATF is offering a $10,000 reward for information for some of these fires that have been going on in the community. This is one of the more notable one, but there have been some other things that have been going on in the community as well. But right now, everybody's very calm. The people we've had a chance to speak to since we've been here, they've been very positive. They're people from the community. They say they don't like this type of activity. Many of the people were very encouraging. But we saw one man, we'll go put the report up earlier or later, where he said that he was trying to teach the kids how to drum, or another lady, she was like, well, we have all these after-school programs and summer programs to keep the kids out of the streets. So there are people trying to do positive things here, but unfortunately, the violent minority gets the bulk of the media attention.
Well, Gary Haben was here yesterday, Ja'Kari, and he talked about the fact that when he was in Louisiana after the police shootings, that all he saw was basically black people, and also a few white folks or pink folks, whatever you call them, out there with signs saying, Jesus loves all the children, let's come together. No media attention to that. And I forgot that some of our reporters have been out in other areas of the country and seen the same thing. So again, there's a media agenda to really hype division here.
Oh, yeah, because we go all around the country. A good example of that, what you're talking about right there, is when the shooting happened in Charleston at the church. And we went out there, it's right in front of the church. The many people who were out there who weren't even necessarily religious or spiritual, they still were out there coming in community, coming together with the community and also with the church and standing by the people in that area. You know, there are no mass riots, none of the kind of stuff that we've seen here or places like Ferguson. I think the worst thing that happened while I was out there was a statue got spray painted. That was it. So, you know, it is possible for these things to come out to a peaceful solution.
Sure.
But for whatever reason, sometimes they do not.
What do you make of the media's agenda then? Why do you think they're trying to stir this up?
Well, I guess they were trying to stir it up until they started getting targeted. But since
oh, yeah, some of the media got attacked up there, didn't they?
Yeah, people got rocks thrown through their windows and all kinds of stuff. And since then, I guess they've stopped hyping it quite a bit because actually we were flying in. We got in late last night and we were looking on our phones trying to find some news. We couldn't find any news. It was like everybody pulled out. Then we got here. It was just us and, you know, maybe one or two other guys out here covering the story. So they've really eased up on the way that they're covering it. And to a large extent, you know, things have cooled down. And you've seen the result of that.
Now, since you got there, you may not have seen this, but you guys are great news hounds. More George Soros emails hacked. They're clearly behind the immigrant waves to destabilize Europe, the U.S. They admit the whole plan. This is a political operation. We already knew that, but wow. What else has to come out on George Soros, Shikari?
Well, I think the problem is a lot of people don't understand that they're being manipulated, you know, because you're intellectual enough to understand this, but a lot of people don't. You know, they just hear, you know, the slogans or, you know, whatever it is that he does to entice them, you know, come out here and protest, get paid $50, whatever the fee is, and they go out and do that. They don't really understand the man that they're operating with, and then I think if more people understood that, they would be more apprehensive to sign up with a guy like George Soros.
I just can't believe there's a real live comic book character that's, like, worse than stuff I read in comic books.
Yeah, he's not a good guy. That's what I was thinking. If people understood who this guy is, you know, because they may have various issues in the community with, you know, this group or that group, but if they understood who that individual was, I think a lot of this stuff would cease very quickly. And of course, you got the agitators, you got the communists who come down to various communities, try to stir stuff up, and they're always going to do that. But they wouldn't have as many people following them if they understood what exactly the agenda was.
Sure. I've studied Joseph McCarthy pretty in-depth. I mean, I'm not a super expert, but I probably read, let's not exaggerate, 10 books or more about him from enemies and supporters. I've looked at the congressional record. The Soviets in the last 20 years, you know, as that empire declined, have declassified a lot. Turns out he was right. A lot of elite foundations and things in the U.S. and England and Europe, France, were funding the communists. So there was that back and forth deal. They were kind of using Russia to go invade countries that they couldn't convince Europe or America to do. So as soon as McCarthy figured that out, that's when they shut him down. When he wanted a police state to basically harass communists on the ground, you know, the government was okay with that. But I got to tell you, when communists say they want to overthrow our system and put us in forced labor camps, and they're always the ones out pushing the violence, I mean, at a certain point, it's like the KKK. It's like, okay, you have a right to exist, but the minute you call for violence, I want you arrested. I mean, it's the same thing. But like, it seems like the communists just get away with whatever they want. And at a certain point, how long do we put up with, like, heirs still walking around, not in prison, Jakari? I mean, when is a group a foreign agitating organization? I mean, Russia has banned Soros inside their country. I can find no fault with that. Do we just let these groups do anything? Is there any point at which these groups are no longer operating under the law, Jakari?
Well, you know as well as I do, Alex, a lot of people come out here and agitate. Those are some of the most cowardly people that we see, whether it's at the abortion rally we went to or other things that we experienced.
Communist,
you know,
again.
You know, skinny college kids who want to come out there and kick up stuff. And then when you stand up to them, they just run away and go hide back in the cave and crawl over trash cans in their skinny jeans. But the issue is that they are so popular amongst, you know, whatever group of people who think that they're in the right. They feel very empowered to go out and do these things. And that's what the issue is. If they understood how ridiculous they are, and I think a lot of them will look back at those videos, you know, 10, 20 years from now and be quite embarrassed. But for the time being, they think that's the thing to do. And it's almost a social problem that they think that this is the way to help the country by burning
it down. No, I agree with you. But I don't care if it's a right-wing group or a Klan group or a Hispanic group or a black group or a communist group or a whatever group. When you start, let me ask Hagman this and come back to Jakari. Doug, you know, you've trained thousands of police officers, FBI, you know, with your intelligence network group. I mean, obviously, there's a point where it's fired. And I'm all for speech, for free speech, 100%. But when you start organizing, if I organize, which I don't want to because it's not effective, I don't want to do it. If I started organizing the type of things I see communists doing or BLM doing or the George Soros white kids getting off the buses saying bang, bang, oink, oink, dead cops, deck the halls with dead cops. When you're there at an event calling for dead police, you're not in free speech. You're organizing an event. If police were running around chanting, let's kill citizens, I'd say arrest their ass. You know, I mean, there's a certain point where the left is allowed to do things nobody else is. And again, I'm not mad like, I want to organize violence. Why can't I? I don't want to organize it. But I watch them doing things that is calls to action, organizing violence. They have a name for it. It's racketeering, isn't it?
Well, of course. I mean, on a federal level, you've got the crimes code at the state level, too, and the local level. You're seeing this being violated, flagrantly violated by these groups, whereas if you and I did this, it would be, we wouldn't even get off the ground. We wouldn't even get out of the planning
stage. If I called for this stuff in 1 hour, the police would be here.
Right, exactly. So this is, I mean, certainly this is how we see and how we can identify the infiltrated. And
we can see the Justice Department is protecting it.
Of course. Right. So, I mean, this seditious activity that violates the federal, state, local laws that can be stopped isn't stopped. And I guess
that you hit the word. It is sedition.
Traitors, sedition, whatever. Absolutely. Because you're talking about overthrowing the government. You're talking about murdering. Of innocent people. You're talking about conspiracy, the actual act of conspiracy with others to engage in seditious acts. So all of this, this is pretty clear. It's pretty basic what we're seeing.
We're facing foreign multinational billionaires engaging in fomenting seditious rebellion and overthrow of our country, just like Soros has done in dozens of countries. I cannot believe he's allowed to operate. Jakari Jackson, I keep going back to Soros, and he's emblematic. He's only one of these kingpins. Carlos Slim, with all of his weird corruption and all the corporate welfare he gets, richest man in the world, runs Mexico. He owns the New York Times. He's pushing gun control here in America. People go, well, are you against him because he's a Mexican? He's not even a Mexican. He's Lebanese. I'm not against Lebanese either. The point is, he's a parasite. He wants my guns. And what is he doing in my country, being the number two financier of gun control after Michael Bloomberg? I'm fundamentally pissed, Jakari.
Well, absolutely. People don't like this. I think we see more and more people waking up to this. Actually, a video that we're going to post here in a little bit. Well, actually, I don't know if we said this on camera. We were talking to a lady a little bit ago, and she may have said this after we got off camera, but she was saying that you guys need to be prepared. She's like, what are you guys doing to get prepared? And Big said, like, we got food, we got bullets, and we got water. And then she gave us a high five. And it's just a normal lady here in the community. She doesn't, you know, she's not an extremist or anything else, but she understands that you need to have a means to defend yourself and also a means to provide for yourself.
I was about to say, there is a total distortion along so-called race lines. When it is true, we're all one race. We all got red blood, all the same genetics. At the end of the day, our differences is less than 0.1%. It's all cosmetic in the spectrum of humanity. But when you look at this, the average person just wants freedom and just wants to have a future. And that's what's so sad and what makes me so angry is that our enemies play us off against each other because it's the only way they can win, Jakari.
Yeah, that's what they do, divide and conquer. That's their best strategy. If they understand that people unify, they understand that people can put aside these petty issues like they did in places like Charleston, they won't have these big riots.
Notice they shut the media down once it showed whites, blacks, Hispanics all hugging at prayer vigils and coming together. As soon as that happened, they just shut that coverage down.
They said, well, that's not what we came here to see. Like you said, they don't want to see the people, thousands of people across the bridge out there in Charleston hugging, singing songs and all that. And I think if more of those things could happen and get the good publicity, then a lot of these things would stop.
Absolutely, Jakari. Well, thank you. We're going to come back and do one segment with Rob Dew, with Mr. Hagman as well. So we're going to get the news director's take on what he's been witnessing and more straight ahead. I have not plugged this out. I want to take some phone calls here with a little bit of the next hour with our guest, Hagman and Hagman.com. Check out his own radio and TV show. It's excellent. Just amazing information. Very humble man, Doug Hagman. Smart guy. A lot of great sources. Paul Watson taking over in about 15 minutes from London. But let's go to real quick to the news director, who's also running camera. Rob Dew, what is your takeaway from what you're seeing happening there in Milwaukee? The Trump event coming up tonight. We're going to have live coverage during the nightly news, 7 o'clock Central. Rob Dew.
Well, Alex, I just want to make a point here of what you were talking about earlier, how the media wants to see death and destruction and exploit that. Jakari, turn the camera over here. You got three mainstream media cameras, and they're all pointed at the burnt-out building. Now, we did shoot some footage of that earlier, but all of them are pointed over there. We're over here. Our backdrop is people having picnics, getting along, coming out here.
This is a first. How delicious is that toothpick in your mouth right now?
The toothpick?
I'm not even mad. I just love how laid back you are with a toothpick in your mouth. Go ahead.
I don't have a toothpick in my mouth, but that's all right.
You do have a toothpick. I see it.
Well, if you want to make a point of it, I'll get real close. This is sunburn from my
gosh, I apologize. It was a distortion. I'm not mad at you. I love the fact you got a toothpick. I think I'm going to start broadcasting with a toothpick. Sorry.
Big. Yeah, I've been dealing with it all day, or for the last 3 days.
I apologize. I was not bitching at you. I thought it was funny.
No, I just wanted to show it wasn't.
Hey, I look like Bob's big boy. Hey, does it not look like a toothpick in a distance?
What I'm trying to do is hide it. Like this.
It's okay. It looks tasty, actually. So, is that caramel flavored?
You got people out here, Alex, selling water. You got a group out here drumming, trying to raise money for their group to go out and perform. This guy's one-man army is trying to take kids off the street, teach them a skill. You know, he was a high school drummer. He's like, I'm going to take kids off the street.
I love this. So all these people that want to help and stop this are coming to bring joy.
Right. Exactly. And so maybe it takes an event like this to wake people up and break people out of their trance. Sometimes you need events like this. But I just think it's very interesting how the mainstream media is all focused on the building being torn down and, you know, not talking to the regular people out here. It's just my observation. From the people we met last night to today, all of them had a biblical message to add to what they were saying. And I think that's pretty important that we have to, like, start looking at God and his message and what's in the Bible to find guidance and direction in these things, because people are running around without guidance and direction. And this is what you get when you don't have guidance and direction. And a lot of people are saying it's the adult's responsibility to take control of the kids to make sure, you know, they're
absolutely
not
sitting. I like what Sheriff Clark said about all this. You know, we can deal with the police later, but how about dealing with the ghetto problem? Because, you know, that's an issue. And the poverty's getting worse for everybody. It's a very sad situation. Well, you're going to be there tonight. Tell folks where this is taking place with Trump.
Yeah, it's going to be at West Bend. I don't have the exact address in front of me, but we're going to be there. We're actually going to leave here in about 15 minutes and head up that way. We got some videos to upload, some stuff to put together. And we're going to see if there's any rollover from this. Maybe the operatives have come in and they're just waiting to spring on Trump, because last night it was pretty quiet here. The police had this place locked down. We went to another location that they were going to be at. And it's going to be in West Bend at the Ziegler Building in Washington County at the Fair Park and Conference Center.
That's about 45 minutes away.
West Bend, Wisconsin starts at 7:30 tonight. We're going to be there in less than 2 hours. So we want to see all the people out there. Hopefully, nice, positive event. But if there's agitators out there, we will get them on film and we will expose them.
Well, like
we
do. You are awesome. And I meant it lighthearted about the toothpick. I didn't realize you had a big sunburn spot. So I put my foot in my own mouth. Great job, you and the crew.
All right. Rob Dew reporting from Milwaukee, Wisconsin for Infowars.com.
All right. We're going to come back in 70 seconds, take a few calls, get final comments from Mr. Hagman, and then we're going to hand the baton to Paul Joseph Watson, while I'm having some fun. You know, I love the crew. We all just joke with each other behind the scenes. Infowars.com, the New Order doesn't want that website out, folks. We are teleprompter free. Remember that.
You're listening to GCN. Visit GCNlive.com today.
Just come on every few months. Just somebody. I'm going to get James Wesley Rawls on. All these great people we don't get on often enough. But I want to go to your phone calls too. Anna and Josephine and Jason and Dan and Carlos. I'll get to all of you before I hand the baton to Paul Joseph Watson. But any other tidbits you want to add as we take a few calls here?
Just that you're right on. You know, it's interesting. The appearance in Wisconsin, what you showed versus what the mainstream media is focusing on. I think we need more of that, and we need to understand too. And this is where I myself, as a Christian, and to my Christian audience, we need to fill in the gap. We need to have a presence, because again, failure to act on our part, we have a responsibility to really to stand in the gap and to be a force multiplier for the good, as opposed to allowing the bad to run roughshod over us, whether it be the alien invasion from ISIS or the globalist tyranny or whatever it might be. But I think the dynamic that you showed,
people coming together, you wouldn't see that on mainstream media.
Exactly. And the other thing you said too about McCarthy, I'm a big history buff about McCarthy. I think people would be surprised to learn just very quickly that even into the 1990s, much of McCarthy's findings from the National Archives We're being expunged by the people who are in power right now, the globalists. And I would urge people to really understand the infiltration that we suffered post-World War II by the communists and even the Democratic National Socialists into America, and how that's playing out today. So thank you for allowing me to say that.
Absolutely. Let's talk to Anna in Kentucky. You're on the air with Doug Hagmann. Go ahead.
Hi, Alex. Thanks for what you do. My question is, since Soros and the big banks have so much control over the government, how is there any possible way that Trump can even win this election?
If we all just wake up and know they're the enemy and spread the word to people and don't just debate them, you'll go, look, you're being conned. You know, Trump is the anti-globalist. Enough people will vote for a landslide. But Trump wins just by injecting real issues. Even if he loses, the globalists are in trouble. Their whole agenda is being exposed.
True. And my son wants me to ask you, he is actually the one that has introduced you to us. And we were just kind of leading blindly, you know, in this world, and until this past election. He is wondering if you, in your opinion, do you think Hillary Clinton had to bow to Moloch to get to be the candidate for the Democratic Party?
Are you saying, do I think she's too ill to be that?
No, if she bowed to Moloch.
I don't think there's any doubt that Hillary Clinton is into the occult. I've read books about it, seen photos. I mean, I've covered what she does, and most of these elites, and I didn't believe this 20 years ago. I got into this and just did research. Most of them are into the occult. They're obsessed with the occult, and there's no doubt Hillary Clinton is an extremely wicked woman. God bless you, and God bless your son, Anna. In your own research, Doug, I'm going to ask you this question. Have you run into the occult when researching the globalist?
Oh, yeah, absolutely, Alex, and you're right on the money with this. People won't believe it. I didn't believe it, but absolutely that there is a level, the Luciferian elite. And if anyone has any doubt, Rules for Radicals dedicated to Lucifer, come on.
That's Hillary's Trust. Bible is absolutely dedicated to Lucifer.
Right. So I mean,
it's everywhere.
Yeah, absolutely.
Soon when it's Lucifer this, Lucifer that, you're like ignoring it. It's just all around you.
Absolutely. Yep.
All right. Well, Doug, thank you so much. I'd love to come on your program anytime, you and your whole team. No, I know you're a busy guy, and you've invited me before and haven't, but I'd love to come on. Your work is so important. Thank you so much for all you do.
God bless you, Alex. Thanks for having me on. Really appreciate it.
No, we appreciate you have a lot of courage, my friend. All right, we're going to come back and hand the baton to Paul Watson after a few calls. I'm Alex Jones. This is The InfoWar, humanity's desperate attempt to fight back. I need to get involved today. And I saw Paul Joseph Watson about 15, 16 years ago with his blog, propagandamatrix.com, and I saw him having a big effect and kind of writing about what I was doing, and I said, I need to hire this guy. And I did. And then I pushed him to get on air and everything else, and now in libertarian news worldwide, Paul Watson doesn't want to brag about it, but he's the hottest commodity out there. And that's what's exciting about human vision. And I see the potential in you as well. We're going to defeat the New World Order. I mean, look at that hunchback demon crone Hillary. Stick a fork in her, she's done. And so all I can say is that I have a new apprentice, younger and more powerful. So, Paul Watson, there is a lot going on. I'm going to take a few calls before I hand the baton to you, as I promised to. What is coming up today in Planet InfoWars?
Well, we had the backlash, Alex, to the Hillary Health scandal that we really brought back to the fore over the past couple of weeks. That viral video that I put out on YouTube got, so far, 2.8 million views on YouTube, another couple of million on Facebook. It sent them into a complete panic. The problem is, Alex, that Hillary just keeps falling over. She keeps being caught in these incidents where...
She's not young and powerful. She's not a Jedi leader.
No, she's nearly 70 years old. You know, John McCain was 71 when he ran for president 8 years ago. At that time, the media was absolutely obsessed with his health. But if we talk about it in the context of Hillary, we're tinfoil hat-wearing conspiracy theorists.
But I kind of like that attack. I mean, our intellectual enemies just say tinfoil, 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 as we rise in the ratings above them and they plunge.
Well, I mean, you can look at the U.S. media top publishers in July, Alex. I mean, Drudge had this up yesterday, I think.
Number one.
Well, he's number two. He's got MSN to beat. But look at the people who are below it.
He's number one overall web, though.
But look at the people who Drudge is beating. Disney Media Networks, Yahoo, Google Inc., Time Warner, Fox, Gannett Company, NBC Universal, Time, New York Times Company. These companies have thousands of employees. They're up against one guy. Obviously, he's got people who help him out. But one guy who started a website out of his apartment.
True. Well, I apologize because the way I read it was number one. I must have seen another story. It was like number one news site in the world. I guess like number two overall in some other aggregator.
If you include MSN, which is a huge conglomeration of different outfits, yeah, he's basically number one. He's kicking the ass. BuzzFeed, kicking their butt. AOL, kicking their butt. With one website, that classic look that still looks like it's from the late 90s, which everybody loves, absolutely whopping them because he dares to point to news articles, which you're not going to see on Yahoo, on Google, etc. And they're just incensed with him. I mean, they write articles about who he links to. That's how incensed they are. And he's been the one pushing, again, this Hillary's health scandal, which is why they're terrified about it, which is why more medical experts
are coming. But Alexa says he has no visitors. Love how Amazon gamed that a few years ago. They're now a total joke with their rating system.
No, I mean, you can put in any website to Alexa, you know, conservative libertarian. It shows that it's plummeted completely at odds with our internal traffic, which shows the complete opposite.
And by the way, we're not web gurus. We don't know how to set all this up. They have Free Speech Systems is 89. We have no website called Free Speech Systems. And then InfoWars is 109. I talked to our IT people. If we combined everything right, we'd be like 54 or something. But it doesn't matter. Free Speech Systems is 81. We don't have a website called that. It's some way it's listed or something. So that's how they keep us from being even listed. They just name our company so no one can actually see it.
Even still, Alex, we were up like 10 places. But, I mean, look at the article we had out Sunday about the riots in Milwaukee. Last time I checked, 17,000 comments. I mean, that's totally crazy. That must have been one of the top articles on the web for that day. We're reaching more and
point
more
is,
people.
We're growing, they're imploding, and so they want to censor now. And
yeah, and it's like, oh, you're so discredited, no one's listening to you, we don't even... I mean, that's kind of a
Paul,
protection in a way.
I have seen thousands of articles, not to obsess on Drudge, but that's who everybody obsesses on, so we have to. I've seen thousands of articles saying Drudge is gone, Drudge is down, Drudge is a joke, Drudge has failed, Drudge doesn't matter anymore. All horsemen are. It shows this ghost dance the mainstream media is doing, and Drudge is just indicative of the rest of the new media.
No, I mean, that's precisely it. There's this narrative that they put out over and over again. Drudge is irrelevant. InfoWars is so discredited. These are the same people who have got 6% trust amongst Americans right now. 6% trust in the mainstream media, all-time record lows, and they think that they have the prerogative, that they have the credibility to stand up there and lecture everybody else.
Sure,
about
and
who
I've said for two decades
to.
They're using giant immigrant groups to come in, to forge them into political groups, to bring in global governance, and now George Soros is hacked, and it says exactly that, exactly what we said, word for word.
I mean, you can look at the Black Lives Matter funding. Again, I tweeted this out earlier. I'll talk about it later. But in just one of those leaked documents, it talks about $600,000 to one particular Black Lives Matter group. We know that it's in the hundreds of millions. The media, up until all along, basically said, oh, that's a conspiracy theory. George Soros isn't funding Black Lives Matter. It's there in the document.
I had Media Matters 5 years ago call me, and they said an investigative journalist from Media Matters wished to interview. And I wasn't even doing interviews then. You know, now, I mean, I had like the London Guardian, New York Times, a bunch of other big publications call and go, we want big profiles. Aren't you honored? And I said, no, no profile. Make up whatever crap you want. That's my answer to them. But I did it just so I could snicker. They had the guy under David Brock on the phone for an hour going, we don't know who George Soros is. We don't get funding. So I was pulling up Federal Elections Commission stuff. You got $3 million this year. And he goes, I mean, they literally think I'm one of their retarded fake liberal readers that can't wipe their ass. I mean, you people are illiberal fascist, satanic pieces of filth. I mean, do you understand, scumbags? We know who you are. Go ahead, Paul.
No, and it's the same with the Daily Beast. They came out with a big hit piece against us last week. Again, owned by a company whose their board of directors includes Chelsea Clinton, vice chair of the Clinton Foundation. They're owned by the Clintons. They're a Clinton mouthpiece. They attack us. They think they're going to discredit us. They're so discredited, Alex, at the Daily Beast, they had to remove the comment section from their website entirely because every single article, they were just getting absolutely
trounced. And by the way, studies show that's what's popular, not the article.
Exactly. They've had studies which show people believe the narrative, the perspective of the article, not from the actual content, but from the comments below it. So that's why the mainstream media is panicking and having to remove them altogether. So they're sacrificing.
Listen, Webster Hubble's daughter may own you, but it doesn't matter.
Exactly. And I mean, I've got another example.
Webster Hubble, always a very handsome man. So is Chelsea.
Well, exactly. The concern is now, Alex, obviously they're just going to undercut that entirely. They're going to forget about censorship on the web. They're just going to come and arrest us. I mean, London's new mayor who, stood on a platform with an ISIS supporter on 9 separate occasions. He's now in control of everything.
And he says he's coming after you, Paul.
Yeah, he's announced this hate crime initiative. He's going to go after people who post offensive.
Look at a little power tripping bastard. Oh, I'm so sick of these people. God, I guess we deserve to be ruled by these people.
Well, I mean, the lesson is, Alex, don't let everything be segregated into those internet ghettos, as Drudge said. They can censor us on Facebook and Twitter, even though,
The lesson is, don't let that mayor come at your daughter's genitals with loppers.
But, I mean, I got literally 3 dozen death threats just over the past 24 hours from Black Lives Matter. Facebook does absolutely nothing about that. I've reported them before. No consequences whatsoever. Yeah, that's progressive, as Sally Cohn says. Sharia law is progressive. That has no consequence. But post the word tranny on Facebook, you'll get suspended for 30 days because that's what's important. Banning the word tranny, not following up on actual death threats. And they lecture us about cyberbullying when that's what they're focused on.
All right. Well, we got a bunch of callers here. If you have time to get to them, if not, understand, they're great callers. They'll understand. I'm going to give all these callers for holding patiently a free Hillary for Prison shirt, limited edition, at InfoWarsStore.com. We're going to go through and get all their addresses. And we're going to make sure we get them, guys. I'm going to send them all a free Hillary for Prison shirt. I want to thank folks for all their support. We built something original here, something real, something brazen, something unapologetic. And when you buy a Hillary for Prison shirt or a Bill Clinton rape shirt or 20% off on the great nutraceuticals out there like Living Defense that we've got right now, it funds this operation. So, Paul, in closing, did you ever think the InfoWar when I hired you 15 years ago would be this effective? Because I'm not bragging about how effective we are. It's just an example of success. It's a success story.
Well, I mean, it's taken hard work. It's taken a lot of commitment. It's taken people supporting us. And buying, back in the day, your VHS tapes in 1999 or whatever, that was the foundation of what it is today. It's gone from, a handful of people to so many employees now, just on a business level, and we're reaching infinitely more people than ever before, and that's why the establishment's terrifying.
Yeah, I got to tell you, what do you make of the Secret Service leaks? Because those are Secret Service leaks we got. We took the risk to do it. I had a really scary feeling doing it, but I knew I had to do it. And then now about how sick Hillary is. And then 2 days later, 3 days later, no coverage. Because they'll cover what we do if a banana peel falls on the ground or, if a leaf falls on my head, it's national news. No coverage. I mean, if I'm discredited, say that I made up the Secret Service leak. I'm a big fan. They will not touch it, Paul. What does that tell you?
It tells you that they're paranoid about the truth about Hillary's health coming out, which it will in dribs and drabs, and she's going to start collapsing more. We're going to see more of that. So they can't hide it anymore.
Well, look, you look at her, she looks hell. I mean, she looks drugged up. She looks really bad compared to even a month ago. They think it's Parkinson's. They don't know. They just know she's falling down all the time and flopping around. What do you think it is, Paul?
Honestly, I'm not a medical person, but all the people I speak to, and since I put that video out, more have flooded in. The Daily Beast was like, oh, the only person he cited was Martin Shkreli, this discredited pharmaceutical oligarch or whatever. Literally in the video were 10 different medical experts quoted in the Breitbart article.
They lie to their viewers.
Secret Service, NYPD officers that have been around Hillary. Since that video came out, a bunch of other neurologists, you know, Dr. Ben Carson, others have been on Fox News.
And by the way, it takes energy every time you're around security to scream at them and tell them they're filth and be mean. I mean, she is a mental patient.
No, if you go back and read the revelations of Secret Service agents, in the White House, she would literally walk down the corridor, but demand that everybody get out of the way into the side rooms so that they couldn't look her in the eyes. That's how demented and on a power trip. It's literally like something out of the Roman Empire.
I just thought of this. I'm going to do a funny video where I'm going to go, I've decided I like Hillary, and read the pages and go, that's normal. And I'm going to walk in and go, don't look me in the eye. And I'm going to walk down the hall and make everybody hide in offices. And I'm going to fall down and convulse and make them cover it up.
No, I mean, that's how she behaves. People have gone on the record so many times. The other thing that they're worried about is this Seth Rich murder and Sean Lucas and the others. Extremely little information coming out about that. But we put a few articles out about it after Assange went on TV and basically said that, you know, Seth Rich was the source of the DNC leak. I was contacted privately by this veteran Democratic Party strategist who has worked with 120 or so Democrats in their political campaigns in the past. He's a Bernie Sanders supporter, so he doesn't like Hillary. And he told me, you're dead on the money with Seth Rich. He says it's extremely fishy. Everybody knows it, that there's a cover-up going on. So that's not somebody who's wearing a tinfoil hat. Somebody who's literally on as major media appearances every week. He's profiled.
Well, Julian Assange has basically said this guy was the source.
Yeah, otherwise, why would he mention it on that Dutch television show? Why would he say that they take...
Let's go ahead and go to your report. It's on InfoWars.com, PrisonPlanet.com. When you come back, you'll take over, Paul. But why not play your clip now? What was it titled? Hillary's Bizarre Behavior?
It's Hillary's Weird Behavior, the cover-up. So it's an update on everything that's happened since and all the new revelations that we've got.
And it's up on InfoWars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. Everybody out there should send this clip to everybody you know, Facebook, Twitter, everybody, and just say, hey, what do you think's going on with Hillary Clinton? Here it is.
Since my video went viral and catapulted Hillary's health back into the national spotlight, we've seen more examples of Clinton behaving bizarrely, completely losing her wits mid-sentence.
We need to make what we've got work really well and improve it and get the costs out of a upward spiral of upward spiral.
Nearly falling over again. Referring to Trump as her husband.
You will compare what I'm proposing to what my opponent is talking about.
Having to be calmed by a mysterious Secret Service agent. Also carries around a weird syringe which some speculate carries an anti-seizure drug. The re-emergence of photos from February showing Hillary being helped up the stairs by the same guy. I've also been privately contacted by more medical experts and neurologists who agree that Hillary has major health problems. More health professionals have also gone on the record.
We have a right to know fully what a neurologist says about this.
If you're going into a very important position like this, it's critical. Right. And that information should be something that we should have access to.
Secretary Clinton has had history of unexplained falls, a fall leading to post-concussive syndrome, which was documented, and then a cerebral venous thrombosis that was discovered post-fall. For both candidates, medical history, neurological history has to be transparent. This is a long and rigorous campaign.
A Secret Service whistleblower also reached out to us privately to reveal how $500,000 has been spent creating disabled access for three SUVs used by Hillary. Hillary herself admitted that she short circuits and gets really tired and collapses. The revelation that she's taking most weekends off. Oh yeah, and this AP reporter claimed that Hillary's behavior was perfectly normal. Okay. But according to Clinton mouthpiece The Daily Beast, The Washington Post, CNN, MSNBC, and others, the whole thing is just a baseless conspiracy.
Total conspiracy theory that literally came from InfoWars.
MSNBC's authoritative medical expert, Charlie Pierce, also completely debunked my claims.
This is just nuts. Yeah. Okay? This is just completely crazy.
Oh, wait. He's actually not a medical expert. He's a game show panelist. But to be fair, they're right. I mean, anyone who questions the health of a presidential candidate simply has to be insane.
Is McCain simply too old to get elected?
If it's John McCain's health we're talking about, and he's running for the highest office in the land, his health, with limits, becomes the public business.
How concerned are doctors that the skin cancer may in fact return?
Unfortunately for the pro-Hillary prostitutes, their spin isn't working. According to a Rasmussen poll, 59% of Americans want to see Hillary's health records.
59% say release medical records. What's wrong with her?
Google searches for Hillary's health are through the roof. Just as John McCain was pressured into turning over his medical history, Hillary needs to do the same. We made this into a national conversation. We forced the establishment media to address it. Now they're terrified. More revelations are coming. Will the dam break, or will the cover-up continue?
That video is entitled Hillary's Weird Behavior, the Cover-Up. And it is up on YouTube as of about 2 hours ago. It's also on Infowars.com. As I said before, the previous video got 2.8 million views on YouTube, probably another couple of million on Facebook. Haven't checked in a while. But again, it reasserted this scandal. It brought it back into the national focus. It forced the likes of CNN, The Washington Post, The Daily Beast, and others to try and debunk this by claiming it was all a tinfoil hat conspiracy theory. Again, go back to 2008, John McCain. Serious questions over his health. The mainstream media was absolutely obsessed by it. They demanded the release of John McCain's medical records. They pressured him to do so. He had to do a 3-hour private closed-door briefing with reporters to lay out, I think it was 1,500 documents relating to his health. Again, he had to go through absolute full disclosure. He was 71 years old at the time. Hillary Clinton is currently 69, I believe. She's approaching 70. And again, all these major signs of health problems, all these neurologists, health experts going on the record. Again, Hannity's had several of them on in the past week or so, saying that she's got major health problems. And we keep seeing signs of it. Again, just yesterday, falling over during the speech with Joe Biden, again, calling Trump her husband. Now we've got a website which is offering $1 million in return for a whistleblower to leak Hillary Clinton's medical records. It claims that it's assembled a group of individual donors who are willing to put up the money to encourage the release of the records. Quote, $1 million can buy you safety. It gives a would-be whistleblower some ease, the Philadelphia-based website said. You can go and link through to their statements from our article at Infowars.com. But again, the media, the mainstream media, just keeps claiming over and over again, oh, Hillary's personal physician said a year ago that she was perfectly fine. Well, of course, A, why do you automatically trust Hillary's personal physician? Like, that's an independent, unimpeachable source. Absolute nonsense. And it was a year ago. Hillary Clinton is getting old. Your health at that age can change a lot over the course of a year. So again, huge questions about this. We've driven it, with your help, back into a national debate. So has the Drudge Report. So have people like Mike Cernovich and others. This is a massive issue going forward. Will Hillary Clinton release her medical records, just like the mainstream media forced John McCain to release his back in 2008? Or will they continue to be part of the cover-up? We'll be back on The Alex Jones Show live in a minute. Stay tuned.
We're on the mark.
Has 6% trust from the American people because of burgeoning alternative media outlets like Infowars.com that, as Alex said earlier, has been allowed to grow only through your continued support. So we got Living Defense, the harmful organism cleanser, now 20% off InfowarsLife.com after being sold out for months. Now is the time to secure your bottle for this discounted price before we completely run out again. Start eliminating toxic and harmful organisms from your body naturally without harmful chemicals. Again, that's Living Defense, 20% off, massive discount at InfowarsLife.com and InfowarsStore.com. where you can get the Hillary for Prison t-shirts, Brain Force, and all the other great products, which again gives us fire in our bellies, allows us to actually go out there and fight this info war, get in the face of the mainstream media, supplant their useless, biased reporting. It's all made possible from you getting the products at InfoWarsLife.com. So please go there and support InfoWars today. Now let's get back into the news here. Obviously, we were talking about Hillary's health earlier. That's a continuing issue. We'll continue to have more revelations about that. As I said, almost every day I'm contacted by people, neurologists, health experts. These aren't internet conspiracy theorists, as the Daily Beast would have it, or CNN. These are health professionals. These are experts. More and more now going on the record saying that Hillary Clinton has major problems. Those problems are going to come to light as the intensification of the stress continues in this buildup to November. Of course, she's going to be debating, unless she tries to get out of that, with Trump at some point. So that could be a major flashpoint. We had the article yesterday, exhausted Hillary Clinton taking long weekends off. Again, they looked at the records. She was having most weekends off. Even in the heat of this dogfight with Donald Trump, she's taking more and more time off before she even gets into office. She's probably going to outstrip President Obama in terms of doing nothing. Of course, him being on the golf course half of the time. But this is a major scandal. They're trying to cover it up. Get that new video out. You made the last one go viral. Make this one go viral and crack this cover up that the mainstream media, the Clinton mouthpiece media, is now engaged in trying to cover up Hillary's health problems. So that is up on InfoWars.com. We've also got this out of Information Liberation, touched on it earlier. Washington Post reporter sanitizes story of black mob violence gets exposed in comments. And again, this is about an incident that happened in Montgomery County. I'm not going to go through it. But basically what happened, there was a disturbance where somebody got beaten up by a huge mob of young men. They quoted the victim, I believe it was, in the comments, or somebody who at least witnessed it. And he called them out in the comments. He actually went into the comments and called out the Washington Post reporter because they didn't mention the little fact that this mob of young men chasing and assaulting another African-American man were all African-American. He pointed it out in the comments, and again, it totally dissolved the article because they leave out these crucial aspects. You saw it with the knockout game. Again, a media-contrived hoax to hide the fact that it was black-on-white violence. We see this over and over again. They've done studies which show readers look at a news article, they scan through the article, and they decide on whether they believe the content of the article based on what the comments say. Studies have been done that prove that, which is why over the past 3 years, you've seen big mainstream media websites remove their comment sections altogether because they then be challenged on their bias. Again, they're spewing absolute BS in the article. They don't want to be called out on it. So instead of having to employ people as all these newspapers collapse because they're completely discredited and no one reads them, instead of actually having to pay to employ moderators to weed out these comments, they simply remove the comment sections altogether. You see it in other news outlets like The Guardian, where they say, oh, we're just not going to have comments on certain articles about race or about immigration. And then in other cases, like The Daily Beast, they simply remove them altogether because they've only got 6% trust of the public. They're completely discredited and they don't want to be challenged on their phony narrative. So you saw another example of it there. And again, yesterday, in terms of Milwaukee, we saw yet another example. And this is Mark Dice who picked up on this. We reported on it as well, where you had the sister of the man shot dead. Again, the gang member armed thug who pointed a gun at cops, Black Lives Matter icon, shot dead. And of course, the sister went on TV, spoke to reporters out on the streets, basically said, this is ridiculous how we're burning down our own neighborhoods. Go into the suburbs, go into the white areas and burn down their neighborhoods. When this sister of this killed individual, you know, again, shot dead by cops in Milwaukee. She came out and said, don't burn down your own neighborhoods. Burn down those white neighborhoods in the suburbs. CNN cut the last part out and said, oh, she's calling for peace. And she's actually calling for people to burn down suburbs in which white people live. They all moved out of central Milwaukee. They all moved out into the suburbs, as I documented in our article on this yesterday. So again, yet another example of blatant media censorship to hide the truth that Black Lives Matter is a violent, racist, domestic hate group. And people say, oh, how dare you take the words of one individual or a few idiots, a few looters, a few rioters, and blame the entirety of Black Lives Matter for that? Well, the very founders of Black Lives Matter say that their ideological guru, the inspiration behind the whole movement, is Assata Shakur. Assata Shakur is a domestic terrorist on the FBI's top 10 most wanted terrorist list who was convicted for killing a police officer. Okay, that's who the founders of Black Lives Matter cite as their inspiration. So don't tell me that this group isn't violent when that's the person whose name they chant at every single protest. And again, we had in Milwaukee shooting, looting, burning, launching violent racist hate crime attacks, as we saw, calling for people to hunt down whites. Literally, oh, look, they're white, get them. Violent, racially charged hate crimes, looting, burning, shooting. A white guy who was a supporter of Black Lives Matter got shot in the neck. These people are violent. And yet, what did the mainstream media keep calling them after all this carnage? Demonstrators, protesters. Can you imagine if a bunch of right-wing rednecks who cited, you know, the Oklahoma City bomber, Timothy McVeigh, as their inspiration, were out in mobs hunting down and beating black people, shooting people in the neck, burning down buildings, looting stores? Would the media call them demonstrators? No, because they've lied from the very beginning about this entire Black Lives Matter narrative. And this is out of the Business Insider. A prominent digital journalist pulls out of Milwaukee. For those who are perceivably white, it's not safe to be here. A well-known journalist who frequently covers civil unrest across the country has decided to leave Milwaukee because of racial tensions he observed while covering protests on Sunday night. And again, this is Tim Pool, and you can go and watch his video where he says, look, they were very, very clear that they were going to physically attack white people, didn't want them to be there. And after this, you know, a guy got shot in the neck. They were literally hunting down white people and trying to drag them out of their vehicles. So people, reporters, they're being beat up, they're being run out of there, they're saying, we got to leave, this is just too dangerous. Now, I posted an image of the guy who was shot dead by cops in Milwaukee on Sunday, I believe, on my Facebook page and said, oh, look, another armed thug, Black Lives Matter's latest icon. Well, lo and behold, I checked my Facebook messages last night, literally 24, if not 36 death threats, dozens more racist abuse from Black Lives Matter supporters. And in fact, I put it up on Twitter, violent threats I received from Black Lives Matter supporters over the last 24 hours. And again, I don't do this because I'm sat here trembling that they're going to come and get me. I don't care. Most of them are barely intelligent enough to string together a sentence. I really don't care. I'm not posting it for that reason. I'm posting it because the media, because Sally Cohn, because CNN over and over again says that this is a peaceful group. It's not a peaceful group. Its foundation, its behavior, its activities, its rhetoric is not peaceful. It's violent. And in fact, you know, I just posted a sampling of the death threats. I mean, I couldn't go through them all, but here's a sample. Again, received within the space of 24 hours from Black Lives Matter supporters. I will find you and kill you, you effing faggot. When I find you, I will kill you. Here's another one. You and Donald Trump is next to die. Don't think because you live in London, you can't be found. Again, these are all just received over the last 24 hours on Facebook. We will find you and we will kill you. Not beating around the bush here. Bitch, I hope somebody kill yo white bleep. Again, I can't even read most of them because they're so profane. I'ma kill you. You bitch ass sucker, they gon' kill you when they find you. Don't come to Milwaukee. Again, this is all because I posted a picture of the guy shot dead by cops where you see him holding the gun with the links to the documentation where he's an actual gang member. And again, this was the response. Dozens and dozens of violent threats. Racist abuse. Again, I don't care. I hold this up as an example of the fact that this is a violent, racist group. These are the kind of people who support it. Yet CNN will never tell you about that. And they'll continue to call people who are shooting guns, burning down neighborhoods, you know, hunting white people in packs. They'll continue to call them demonstrators. That's how the media props up Black Lives Matter. You know, Time magazine, they had the headline 2 years ago now, in defense of rioting. The media, the Obama administration, has given what is a domestic hate group, violent and racist, legitimacy, and that's why these riots continue to be a problem. In fact, we had the story about the alderman there in Milwaukee, who again came out after the riots on Sunday night and said, look, there's going to be more riots unless you fix, quote, oppression. Yeah, I guess looting stores for hair extensions is also to address oppression. That's a form of fighting injustice. It's not just criminals taking this opportunity to engage in criminal behavior. I'm sure that's not what's going on here. Again, the alderman came out and said, look, if, you know, you had the guy on the Facebook video that we posted. Rich people aren't giving us enough money. This is going to happen over and over again if you don't give us more money. Again, this criminal chic gangster lifestyle that's been sold to black communities that's completely, you know, eviscerated their chances of improving themselves, of getting out of the ghetto. Again, this is what causes this kind of behavior. Literally dozens of death threats simply for posting a picture of the guy shot dead by cops in Milwaukee. And CNN and Sally Cohn still have the nerve to claim that this is a peaceful movement. Now, speaking of Sally Cohn, we'll be back in the final segment. She's come out today and said that Muslims who believe in Sharia law are progressives. We'll get more into that after the break. Keep it locked in, Infowars.com. 20% discount right now at InfoWarsLife.com. Get the products and support the broadcast. Now, of course, Donald Trump came out yesterday with his extreme vetting proposal where, God forbid, he said that people coming into the United States would have to support equality, women's rights, LGBT rights. Of course, the left, the regressive left, was absolutely horrified about this because they don't support equality. Because they're complete hypocrites. They're not real liberals. They're regressive leftists. They will sacrifice their principles on a whim in the name of political correctness. So CNN's Sally Cohn came out with this tweet about 5 hours ago. Hey, Donald Trump, many progressive Muslims, the ones we should support in the ideological fight against extremism, believe in Sharia. That's right. CNN's Sally Cohn is saying that Sharia law is progressive. Okay, let's just run through a quick list of the characteristics of Sharia law, okay, under Islam. Theft is punishable by amputation of the right hand. That's progressive. Criticizing or denying any part of the Quran is punishable by death. That's progressive. Criticizing Muhammad or denying that he is a prophet is punishable by death. That's progressive. Criticizing or denying Allah, the God of Islam, is punishable by death. That's progressive. A Muslim who becomes a non-Muslim is punishable, you guessed it, by death. That's progressive. A non-Muslim who leads a Muslim away from Islam is punishable by death. A non-Muslim man who marries a Muslim woman is punishable by death. A man can marry an infant girl and consummate the marriage when she is 9 years old. A woman can have one husband who can have up to four wives. Muhammad can have more. a man can beat his wife for insubordination. It goes on and on and on. And according to CNN's Sally Cohn, it's all progressive. Yes, yeah, she actually came out and said that in a tweet. I guess this is progressive as well, out of the Express. Transgender woman killed after she is mutilated and burned in street attack. The body of a transgender woman has been found mutilated and burnt in street in the latest of a string of gay hate crimes to rock Turkey. Turkey is 99.8% Muslim. They don't tend to like LGBT people, which is why Donald Trump came out with this extreme vetting proposal to say that you need to believe in LGBT rights to be allowed into the country. But according to Sally Cohn, that's not progressive enough. We need to believe in Sharia law, which completely disenfranchises women, disenfranchises gay people, leads to them being thrown off the top of buildings, because again, that's progressive. Another progressive thing here out of the Express, girls as young as 9 forced into marriage by imams and authorities are powerless. Marriage amongst migrant children living in Germany is on the rise, with girls as young as 9 made to take part in sick wedding ceremonies. Again, under Sharia law, according to CNN's Sally Cohn, that is progressive. It's progressive to have your hand chopped off for theft. You know, female genital mutilation, that's progressive. Forced marriage, that's progressive. Stoning women to death who are accused of adultery, that's progressive, according to the regressive left, according to CNN's Sally Cohn. Moving on, this is out of Truth Revolt. Feminists, all men are rapists. Feminist commit such charming people with all their talk of castrating God and killing babies in the womb. Only a man drowning in the excess of his own misogyny would reject a date with somebody as the lovely Julie Bindle. Again, she went on Twitter and basically said that all men need to be put in prison and shot dead, because that's progressive. She won't be banned. She'll be free to continue that hatred. That's going to wrap it up for the show. I will be back tomorrow with Mike Cernovich talking about Hillary's health. InfoWars Nightly News coming up, and stay tuned for the website, InfoWars.com. You'll find all the breaking news there.
Thank you for listening to GCN. Visit GCNlive.com today.